lines in a blender following that opening loss to Sweden. Head coach Jeff Truitt staying pat when it comes to the line combos today. The only change, well, newcomer Riley Height will split time on that top line with Andrew Crystal. And Dave, Canada definitely needed that performance against Germany, gain a little confidence, show that, yes, the sky is not falling. The sun did come up a couple days ago again, but I know Jeff Truitt and the coaching staff have to be happy with a lot of things that they saw in that win, but what stood out to you the most?
Their power play, and not just the fact that they scored four power play goals, but it's how they scored the goals. They were trying plays to the middle. They were trying to force the puck to the middle. When that wasn't working, they changed it up quickly, and they started to do the low play. Nick Larson starts it off with the first power play goal of the game. When the power play isn't working, you've got to try different things. They do it again, but they're able to score quickly on plays. They score on the rush. Lukas Dragicevic with a beautiful rush chance all by himself, and then the typical one-timer, moving the puck up to the outside, moving the puck around the box and getting outside shots. They had good traffic as they went along with their power play, which they didn't get early. Nick Lardis with three goals in the game. He had two power play goals, a very quick release, very fantastic goal score, 25 goals in 46 games after his trade to Hamilton. The Oakville native was on point with his shot. I think the power play is going to be significant because Slovakia's power play has been strong in the tournament. They score every single game. But so for me, I think that's going to be the difference. It's which power play is best in this game.
Slovakia has also already shown this tournament they're not pushovers. Ask the Czechs, ask the Swedes. We are just moments away from day four kicking off at the men's U18s.
The sun came up. One game doesn't win you or lose you a tournament. Down low, across, Lawrence shoots, score! And there it is! Winds up the speed. He'll bring it in himself. Dragicevic, wrist shot, score! And what a goal, Lukas Dragicevic. Canada, great bounce back performance.
You got a minute? How about all weekend? Let's go. Ahora, I'm a Miami hotel. I'm looking for someone who loves Art Deco elegance, good times, and unexpected flavors. Someone who likes it hot, but knows how to keep their cool. A white sand beach where you can see the sunrise. Way better than whatever you were going to binge watch this weekend. And you can be here in half the time. Find me at hotels.com.
Chevrolet Silverado factory lifted trucks. Where will they take you? Silverado ZR2, LT Trail Boss, and Custom Trail Boss. Because adventure is everywhere.
Join the fans of Canada's game across the country and around the world and be a Hockey Canada insider. Receive news and features about Team Canada, events, promotions, and much more. Sign up at hockeycanada.ca/insider.
Just after 1 p.m. local time on this Sunday afternoon, and welcome back to Switzerland. Ajoie inside Raiffeisen Arena as we continue our coverage of group play between Canada and Slovakia. There's your referees for the game this afternoon. The refs from France and Czechia, the men running the lines from Denmark and Czechia as well as Canada. Beautiful performance versus Germany, that 8-0 win, and they go right back with Carson Bjarnason, made 11 saves in that shutout versus the Germans, also picked up an assist as well. Meantime, it is Lukas Fersten getting the start, his first start of the tournament. No Samuel Urban, who faced 52 shots versus Sweden as they nearly stole one from Sweden in that game. So Fersten, 13-5-0 record back home in the U20 League in Slovakia. And the head coach, Jeff Truitt, he knows this is a big-time game. He knows that Tibor Tertel and this team will forecheck hard, will come at them very tough. They squeaked out that big win versus Czechia, Craig, and it'll be all systems go here for Team Canada. A critical game when it comes to trying to get second in the group.
Yeah, no question about it. And I got to be honest, I'm stunned that Samuel Urban is not playing in the net. He was brilliant against Sweden, gave him a chance to win, and they had a day off.
Richie, Celebrini, and Wood up front for Canada to start the game. Wood gets a touch as it bounces it. In comes Callum Ritchie on the forecheck early with Celebrini for Team Canada. Stirback As young defenseman plays it up the right side. Second in tournament ice time is Maxim Sturback, the captain for Slovakia, as he plays around 25 minutes per game.
A little bit of jostling going on here between Matthew Wood and Maxim Sturback, having a little conversation as they go off the ice, and kind of a little of an indication of these players understanding that their competitive level has to be high right from the start of this game. And you're seeing it now with Riley Height, the faceoff. You mentioned about Slovakia. Slovakia is going to compete, and Canada has to be ready to match that.
Riley Height arriving yesterday, joining the team, as the 18-year-old now brings some nice offense, 97 points this season back home with Prince George of the Western Hockey League. And another one of those gold medal winners from the Hlinka Gretzky as well. There is Caden Price wheeling in for Canada. Price round the net. Raft try right in front. Score on the doorstep. Kobe Barlow has his first, and it is 1-0 Canada.
A decisive play by Caden Price. No delay, taking the initiative and coming right down on the wall and coming below the net. Kobe Barlow, he knows how to get open in the offensive zone, but Height is on it quickly, and then Caden Price just sizing it up, and then now he sees an opportunity, and what a pass right across to Kobe Barlow. And we've seen him have some chances, and we've seen him kind of be stopped on some plays that were really good. He's not missing on this one, and he doesn't. So just a superb play by Caden Price, taking the initiative and delivering the 1-0 lead for Barlow.
50 seconds into the game, the goal from Kobe Barlow. Now, after the play, unfortunately, there's a Slovakia player in the corner in some duress.
It is Franciszek
Dezs, and he is on his skates, and that is a good sign as he's slow to get back to the bench.
Here's how it happened to Dezs. Coming back to the net, you can see where Caden Price just backs right into him as he's making that pass. Kind of an innocuous, innocent play. Probably had the wind knocked out of him more than anything.
Perfect start for Jeff Truitt, the head coach of Team Canada, up 1-0 here on Slovakia's Pioja off the left side. He'll deliver it in. Back for it, Pertucci. Racing after it is Varga. Varga will chip it, and it comes right to Andrew Gibson. Nice move in his own zone. Gibson flips that to the left wing for Howe. Tanner Howe delivers it in. Shoulder check from Pioja. He'll move it to Cesar, hit by Gibson. Gibson digs it free. Lardis, he'll work it across. Bertucci shoots, and it's handled by Firstin. Catton in the corner, trying to dig it out for Team Canada with Mac Donnell all the way down the ice for Gibson. He'll retreat and pick it up for Team Canada. Stretch pass just behind Catton. He'll have to delay. Canada gets back onside. Catton throws it in. Lardis and Mac Donnell cruising in for Canada. As Nick Lardis, the hat trick versus Germany, helping spark the offense and get Canada on the board. Here's Mac Donnell. Angus Mac Donnell leaves it. Catton comes back to the line, over for Lukas Dragicevic. He'll throw it across for Burns. Cycle continues. Sturback. He'll pick it up in the corner for Slovakia. Popped in the line, but not out. Burns keeps it in. Trying to curl away from traffic. Dragicevic, nice little move far point. He'll work it down low. Lardis spinning away. He'll dish up top. Dragicevic over for Burns. Burns thought about walking it in. Off the boards, back up top. Catton. Berkeley Catton, wrist shot hit. Parikka still stays in the zone. Canada trying to change on the fly and keep the pressure on the offensive zone, and they will. Off the toe or Catton. He gets stumped trying to bring it right in front of the net, and Martone jumps on the ice and into the play. And finally, it's Zedzo able to poke it there to center ice, and a much needed change for Slovakia. In comes Alex Fran with pace, so he'll bring it in. Try to center it in front. Dragosevic pinching in. He'll slap it down. They'll pass in front. Halliburton right on. Still loose. And a sprawling Lucas Verschin as Ty Halliburton nearly jammed one in to make it 2-0.
We're 3 minutes and 10 seconds into this game, and Canada has served notice that they're going to attack Slovakia, and they're going to be on them. They're going to pressure them. They're going to go to the net. Jeff Truitt wants pace. He wants tempo. He wants to see players getting to the net and getting those pucks in and around the net. And Canada has done exactly that in the first 3 minutes and 10 seconds. Really backing up Slovakia.
Canada losing the opener 8-0 to Sweden. Big time bounce back. They win 8-0 versus Germany. Slartis the hat trick. Wood had a pair. Dragosevic, Richie, and Marton. All getting involved for Canada offensively. Some nice touches in that game to get some momentum and settle into the tournament. All about building in a tournament like this and gaining that confidence, getting better each and every game. Here's Halliburton finishing his body check in the corner. Ferran also delivers a hit. It's played up left side. Jammed in by Sedso. He'll drop it off. Dvorsky, one of the top players for Slovakia, Dalibor Dvorsky, ranked third amongst NHL Central Scouting for European skaters. Baran, he took a big hit from Ferran, and he's slow to get up. Bertucci at the line. Yakimchuk accepts the pass. Delaves, shoots, hits Celebrini. Rebound follow-up, and that hit the side of net. Good job by Celebrini in front providing a screen. Bertucci across. Matthew Wood, a good look, and Burston under serious pressure here in the opening 5 minutes of the game. Slovakia trying to clear. They cannot. Richie shoots, deflected in front. Wood follows up, tried to jam it in just wide as Wood coming off a two-goal performance versus Germany. Yakimchuk lost the puck, and Pekarsik on the move. Backhand flip. Zhenko trying to break in, but a good recovery from Yakimchuk as he broke that up. Sturback, though, quickly brings it back in. Zhenko, pass across, Dez shot, interrupted, never got through. Zhenko, he'll follow up, gets the puck back. Efrayesi, in front for Dez, fanned on the one-time try, and it comes to center ice. 5 minutes in, Slovakia trying to mount a little bit of a pushback. Zhenko wrist shot. That was blocked. Follow-up just wide as Bertucci's left wrist. He's shaking that hand. He got clipped, but he's on the puck now and appears to be okay. Stretch pass Barlow. The goal scorer for Canada, Colby Barlow. Up to the near point. Back to Colby Barlow. He'll leave it. Play below the goal line. Stavelitz gave it away to Barlow. Sends up top. Here's Lucas Dragosevic. Dances it to the backhand try, and he put that wide. Andrew Crystal. He'll pick it up. Gets it back. At the line. Just held in, and now it comes out. As Dash will throw that into the corner. So a good start here for Canada. Really pushing the pace and playing on their toes. Kuchenberg, who tied it up versus Sweden late in the game to make it 3-3 before Sweden found an answer late. Slovakia gave Sweden all they could handle in their game, and of course the win versus Czechia. Good job by Crystal. Assess the options and goes back to Dragosevic. Canada getting some fresh legs out. McDonnell, turnover, Rizon space, puts it across, that drive handled by Carson Bjarnason, who hasn't seen a lot of action yet in this period. That is a big test and a good save for him. Here's Catton quickly, in transition, backhand feed in front, tried to jam it in, didn't get through. Catton's on it again, tried to get it through, that hit a stick, and never made it all the way through to Lucas Verschin. Pioja brings it in with Babizel. Good stick check. McDonnell trying to poke it free. Still bouncing around. And Cameron Allen, the captain, tried to swing it away. Pass in front. And intercepted and collected by Berkeley Catton. 7 minutes into this first period. Good pace thus far. Colby Barlow, the lone goal scorer to make it 1-0 Canada here in Switzerland. Halliburton. Going to the far boards. Big hit delivered there by Cameron Allen playing some physical hockey here in this first. Mesnika trying to dance in. Back check by Martone. Penalty coming up as Martone's going to go to the box. Slovakia on the power play when we come back to Oshawa.
Online betting is booming. Booyah! Woo! Oh, yeah! You can win big! But you could also lose. There is risk with online gambling. And that's a reality nobody's shouting about. Learn about safer play at knowtherisks.ca.
Now you can shop smarter at Canadian Tire, which means shopping whenever you want, however you want. Enjoy fast and easy locker pickups. Shop smarter at Canadian Tire, in-store and online. Shop smarter at Canadian Tire. Use the aisle locator on the app or kiosk to find all the products you need faster, especially when your dog gets skunked. Shop smarter at Canadian Tire, in-store and online.
Porter Martone finds himself in the penalty box, and you reach in. He's done a good job. He forces Vetsnichka to his backhand, and he's running him right into Haliburta. Just pass him off. That's something young players have to learn, like understanding, hey, don't take a penalty there, because where Slovakia had success in getting back into the game versus Sweden was on the power play.
Five goals in the tournament so far for Slovakia, trying to get the equalizer here in the first on the power play. Sturback waits, wrist shot, knocked down in front, never got through to Bjarnason, and here comes the center ice. Celebrini shorthanded, cutting in, big diving play as Firston, he gambled, dived, and able to make that poke check. Pretty good play from Lucas Firston. There's Pekarsik. Dalibor Dvorsky. Cross ice, Mesnika charging in. Played below the goal line. Cesar around the boards. Dvorsky. He'll collect. Met by Celebrini. Dvorsky far corner. He'll feed the point. Sturback. Wrist shot. That was tipped high behind the glass. Haliburta trying to clear, and he will. Ty Haliburta with a second effort.
What a good play by Ty Haliburta. At the end of a shift, and he understands that they need to make a line change. He doesn't try to make a play, just get the puck down the ice. That's just such great situational awareness.
Good clear again by Canada. 47 seconds left in the minor penalty. Alex Brand's there first. Brand into the corner. McDonough going to work, as Jeff Truitt was very complimentary of the play of Angus McDonnell and providing a spark, penalty killing energy, and really creating some havoc against the opposition. Radisek Dej driving in, had it stripped off his stick, and again, pretty sharp penalty kill thus far here for Team Canada. 10 seconds remaining in the minor penalty. And that'll be icing charge versus Slovakia. So good job for Canada as far as what a chance, shorthanded.
Well, Macklin Celebrini, he's got real top-notch quickness. And he recognizes that Sturback's in trouble and he can get there. Well, Thurston, he gets out and extends himself as much as he can extend himself. The puck gets up and over him, but not past him. And Celebrini, who's quick, and he understands what he's got to try to do. And a little bit of a poke check saves Thurston from the score being 2-0 for Canada.
Celebrini, 86-point season for the Chicago Steel in the USHL this year, leading that team in scoring, dynamic player in that league. Not dropped eligible until 2024. So Team Canada full strength, 5-on-5, as they kill it off in a 1-0 advantage. Here's Lukas Dragicevic. He had a beautiful goal end-to-end versus Germany on the power play, and Canada will be charged there with icing.
Well, Canada building from the German game, and certainly a better Slovak team that they're facing here. But, you know, the first 6-7 minutes of this period, you know, Canada was establishing themselves in the offensive zone, really putting Slovakia under all kinds of stress and duress, and maybe could have another goal, but absolutely the way you want to play if you're Jeff Truett.
Promiak back for Slovakia. In comes Colby Barlow. Barlow finishing his body check. Braun through center ice. Marika drops. Kron's wrist shot nearly off for Tucci. And wide of Bjarnason. Jeff Truett made little doubt that Carson Bjarnason is his guy. He hesitated about, well, not at all when he said we're going back to Carson Bjarnason. Number one ranked goalie by NHL Central Scouting for North American goalies. Nice year in Brandon as Lardis in shoots. Nick Lardis looking for his fourth of the tournament, and Lucas Bjersten's been busy. Good save there, but Canada, a 1-0 lead on the goal by Barlow.
Welcome to Casper. Here, a cozy night's sleep is crafted piece by piece. Awaken the potential of your well-rested self. Casper.
Yo, H&R Block found me a huge refund on my tax return. I got paid in GovCoin.
GovCoin?
Yeah, dude, it's like crypto, but it's issued and backed by the government.
It's got an NFT of a loon on it.
File before the May 1st tax deadline at H&R Block.
Book that trip to Vegas.
In this economy? What, are we rich? Are we rich? Oh, what a relief. No more secretly renting the attic to that scary lodger that I had at the reservoir.
We're not rich. I use Kayak to compare hundreds of travel sites to get a great deal on our flight, car, and hotel.
Who goes to the reservoir?
Kayak. Search one and done.
Lukas Dragicevic had 75 points in 68 games this season with Tri-City Americans. He was fourth amongst defensemen in scoring in the Western Hockey League. And this goal was versus Germany on the power play. He didn't see anything, so he said, you know what? Yeah, I'll just take this in, snipe. End-to-end rush. What a goal from Lukas.
Sure was. And, you know, a power play that hadn't really done anything. And he did something about it.
Took matters into his own hands, that beautiful end-to-end rush. And he was one of many frustrated players after that disappointing loss versus Sweden. But, you know, full credit to the coaching staff and Jeff Truett. You know, the sun came up. The sky wasn't falling. It's one game. It's a long term. And really, that first period, they just got behind it against a very strong Sweden side and couldn't battle back. Here's Lardis off the draw. Wrist shot just wide. Nick Lardis, he's had a really strong tournament as well. The three goals versus Germany, really competing and playing hard.
We saw it on the first goal with Caden Price, but Canada's defense have become way more comfortable playing on the big ice, coming down, pressing down in the offensive zone, keeping pucks alive, which keeps the pressure on Slovakia. Tristan Bertucci did it, Carter Yakimchek did it earlier, and we saw on the first goal how Caden Price doing it. So getting comfortable with the defense now, forcing the play and making sure that Slovakia has no easy passage out of their zone, really, really important. That's where Canada wants to establish that offensive zone game.
Jeff Truett, in conversation just before the game, Craig, was really happy with a turnaround effort versus Germany. Just much better effort, the push, getting to the dirty areas and engaging play, jumping into the play, and was a lot happier with the performance. They had a nice day off yesterday, had a nice team dinner together as well. And the thing that continues to come up with this Team Canada team, how great the guys are in the room and how tight they've come together so quickly, which is an awesome sign in a quick tournament like this. Mac Donnell, the steal right around Dej as he circles around. Berkeley Catton. Catton across, Gibson shoots and he missed the mark. McDonough again, tenacious on the forecheck, as is Lardis. Gibson pulls the puck free. Bertucci, wrist shot up high, and he whistled it high and wide. Gibson, he takes contact from Pekarsik. Good body check there. Gibson tries to give it right back. Physical play right along the boards. Here's Dej, little pop pass up for Jenko. Cruising in, Jenko, drag move. And that was a good defensive play. Getting down was Andrew Gibson to take it away. Here comes Richie. Space. Richie. Great stop. Hurston laid out, and Richie couldn't elevate that puck as he was in. Price Slap pass. Richie to the forehand, just tucked it wide. He tried to bring it to the forehand and get one by Verston. What a shift here by Team Canada. Matthew Wood up for Allen. The captain Allen across for Price. Price towards the net. Deflected, still loose. Richie jabbing for it right in the crease area and flipped out just in time by Franisek Dej. It was lying there in the crease as Verston thought it was covered. It was not. Price through center ice. He's hit by Varga. Price back in his own zone. He'll flip that to center. Cameron Allen lays it back for Caden Price. Up ahead for Richie. Callum Richie. Oh, nice little move. Richie tried to deliver to Celebrini. Celebrini in the corner. That's off a skate. And it's 2-on-2 the other way. Cesar leading the rush. Cesar protects the puck. Gregosev, a good job to stick right with him. Martone up ahead for Haliburton. He takes contact into the bench. Martone, though, on the move up that right side. And a penalty coming up, boarding a call.
Well, Cal Ritchie gets a glorious opportunity. Backlund Celebrini, great defensive play, and then the little backhand on the move to Richie, and Richie just runs out a little bit of room, and I think Thurston surprised him by going down. Then right after that, nice little play into the net area. Thurston's trying to get it. Richie pokes it, and you can see where Thurston is trying to get it up, and this is the boarding penalty on Ty Haliburta. So now Canada an opportunity on the power play. A power play Dave Reed was talking about got a lot better against Germany, and you know, you can look at the stats and say they were good, but the first two power plays in that game were not good, but then they really adjusted and got their power play process in real good order.
Roman Kukenberg in the box. Canada controls off the draw, so on the power play trying to make it 2-0. Pass across, Celebrini towards the net. Good save by Verston. And a clear by Slovakia.
Riley Height moving right in here on the power play.
Dragosevic will drop it back. Played in for Matthew Wood. Wood. Great season in UConn, Matthew Wood. NCAA, Dragosevic. Back up top, Heights starting to play. Celebrini, Dragosevic, Celebrini, they play catch. Riley Heights, pop pass right in front. A good kick save there. They had Barlow all queued up, and Verston was ready. Dragosevic over to Heights. Back up top. Dragosevic for Heights. Dragosevic. Back to height, far circle, seam pass, Celebrini in front, had Wood, and he just couldn't get the stick on it. And the puck did come out, so Canada's got to reset, check up, and race back in, allowing Slovakia to clear. Mesnichka, he's coming in quick, and Bjarnason will play it up ahead for Berkeley Catton. Close play hit the line, Canada in onside, Crystal.
Crystal thought they were calling offside. He stopped.
That was a fan's whistle in the small building. Allen towards the net. Lardis picks it up. Richie set some glorious chances in this first period. Crystal, little backhand for Allen. Cameron Allen thought about the shot. Crystal was off his stick, goes below the goal line. In comes Catton. He'll dig it free. Up for Crystal. Crystal blocks in, shoots, never got through. Good block, and Slovakia doing a good job here on this penalty kill. So strong work by Slovakia. They're back to even strength in a 1-0 game here for Team Canada. There's a turnover. Kukenberg, Cesar couldn't get the shot away. Bertucci and escapes, and that goes right through the crease as Kukenberg was looking for the opportunity. It comes Martone. Martone, that little chip to the side of the net, and that'll be squeezed as Porter Martone trying to get something in front. 1-0 Canada here on this Sunday afternoon in Oshawa.
EGO, the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power, brings you the world's first power load string trimmer with Line IQ. So smart, it loads the line automatically. With Line IQ, there's no bumping, so you can work faster. Find an EGO retailer near you.
You know that Royal Tiger Towel paper towel is Tiger Strong, but did you know it's carbon neutral? Tiger Towel is part of an organization that plants millions of trees each year and responsibly manage forests. Royal, trusted quality, carbon neutral.
Hockey fans, get your Hockey Canada gear at shop.hockeycanada.ca, the official online store of Hockey Canada, and the largest selection of Hockey Canada gear anywhere. Get jerseys, men's and women's tees, hoodies, headwear, and more. Don't miss out. Shop now and get today's special offer. Shop.hockeycanada.ca, a Fanatics experience.
One of the Canada leads. Look at the Slovakia bench and head coach Tibor Tortel, Michael Dostal, and Josef Stumpel, longtime NHLer. 677 points in his NHL career, all part of the coaching brass. Down 1-0 in this critical game versus Canada in group play. Both teams coming in to this afternoon's action with a win. Canada with some great chances on the power play, even shorthanded. And thus far, Lukas Ferstin has kept it a 1-0 game, as that'll pop into the Slovakia bench. Great fan support wherever these nations travel. It's always cool to see the jerseys and the excitement, whether it's parents in the crowd or fans of the game. One of the best parts about this tournament is meeting with people from all around the world, whether it's media, the fans, the parents. Real cool experience. And talking to the Team Canada brass, sounds like a lot of the Team Canada parents will be arriving today as well, if not here already. So be a little bit louder here as we get closer to the quarters and the middle round. Shots 11-4 Canada right now. Faced off to the left of Lukas Ferstin. Comes back to Allen. He'll lay it across. Bobbled there on Price. He'll recover and work it in. As for Jesse, takes a hit from Height. Turnover. Barlow tried to get it back to Height. He'll try again. There's Sturback and Height. Height in the battle. On the puck for Canada. Up for Allen. Allen zips that across. Price makes some moves and he'll throw it back in deep. There goes Barlow to work with Howe. As Barlow goes down, Sturback trying to free that puck. He is a workhorse for Slovakia, playing big-time minutes in this tournament. Allen towards the net. I think that popped out. Yeah, and it was. A little check up. That's offside. Canada back onside. Slovakia on the move. Pekarsik, good speed in, shoots. And it's up high on Carson Bjarnason. And Pekarsik is one of those dangerous players for Slovakia to keep an eye on. He can light you up in a hurry.
Great play out of their zone, and they move with speed coming out of their zone. And Pekarsik is quick, and he makes a good play here, but so does Bjarnason, making sure that he holds his angle and stays upright as Pekarsik tries to get it up and over the right shoulder. That's just good, solid goaltending by Bjarnason against a player that can put the puck in the net and challenge you.
Pekarsik had a goal versus Sweden, part of their big push to tie up that game. It was 3-3 versus Sweden late until Sweden found a way and then an empty net goal. Just over 3 minutes remaining in this first period. Here's Dragosevic in his own zone. He'll play it over to Burns. Quinton Burns, that pop free to Mancika. Mancika in front, wrist shot, big stop in front. Bjarnason's best save of the game thus far. Zedzo wanted Mancika. That's poked up ahead. As Larnas was on the move, he got tripped up. And Slovakia back on the block. They'll turn it over, and that shot, Larnas, that might have clipped the bar and stayed out. Larnas has had some looks this game and this tournament. And finally, Carson Bjarnason is going to cover up. A little tangle up in the crease. Burns involved. Great chances in this period.
Well, Slovakia gets a great opportunity. The puck comes up the boards, and Berkeley can't handle it. And Bjarnason has to get right to the top of the crease to make a really good save. And then it comes right back the other way, and Lardis right off the bar. He can really shoot that puck. And just a really good quick release. doesn't give the goaltender a real opportunity to get a good read on it. That close to making it 2-0 for Canada.
There's Celebrini on the move. Canada trying to come in numbers just out of the reach of Wood as he couldn't get there in time. Turnover, Richie, side of the net. And again, Fersten sprawling around. He's back on his skates in his crease. Good body check in the corner from Pravlovic. Canada though still controls. Gibson just holds it in. Celebrini circles around. Celebrini, watched by Kuchenberg, try to get it in front for Wood. Clear it up, the pass behind Cesar, comes all the way to Bjarnason. Yakimchuk's back. Carter Yakimchuk up that left wing, he'll poke it up ahead. Under 2 minutes to go in the first. That's for Jesse in the corner. He takes contact, but he's able to work the puck up ice. Cesar, he'll bring it over the line. Cesar, Parikka, and Yakimchuk. Good stick, he'll deflect that out of play.
Interesting here, you have Macklin Celebrini and Leo Essi, teammates with the Chicago Steel and the USHL. They have a bye in the first round, so they gave an opportunity to those two players to come over and represent their country. You know, development takes a lot of different paths, and you know, you got to really respect the Chicago Steel by saying, hey, that's another part of your development. Go and play. When you come back, we'll begin the playoffs, and it's part of our group and an important part of our group.
Adam Fantilli played there and in that league, wins the Hobie Baker this year, part of his path, part of Team Canada last year.
They did the same, Nick Moldenhauer, the same situation with Adam Fantilli and Nick Moldenhauer coming over last year from the Chicago Steel.
As for Jesse losing it, Martone cutting in. Martone round the net. Halliburton is parked in front, battling for space. Bouncing puck. Halliburton was reaching for it, and it pops out of the zone. Brand finishing his body check. Sedzo in the corner. Two goals in the tournament for Sedzo. He gets taken down. Final minute here in Oshawa. 1-0 lead for Canada here at the under-18s. Backhand drive from Dvorsky. Missed the mark. Pravlovic in the corner. Pass in front. Dvorsky battling. Dvorsky. Good work to free the puck. He'll set it up top. That shot missed by a few feet. Pioja pinching in. There's Price. Little backhand. They'll leave it there. And Ferran trying to clear. Mesnika able to hold the line momentarily. And that's backhanded and hits the Team Canada bench with 25.4 to go.
You know, Ty Halliburton, Dalibor Dvorsky were just having a conversation and they were coming off the ice. Make no mistake, all these players know where the other players are ranked on their opposite team. They do. They know, and they want to show, hey, we can do it. Over 200 NHL personnel here.
Puck in front, handled by Bjarnason.
And the NHL personnel are saying, show us what you got. Show us what you got. This is a big-time competition. And top-end players, show us what you got. You don't get this opportunity to evaluate a Colby Barlow versus a Dalibor Dvorsky. Steve Yzerman, president and general manager of the Detroit Red Wings, Chris Draper, Håkan Andersson, just a superb scout with a superb scouting record over the years.
15 seconds left in the period. Racing after it is Tanner Howe trying to get the puck. He hits third back hard into the boards. 6 seconds left. Canada trying for a quick last strike. Dragosivic shoots. That hit Cesar, went wide. Bouncing at the side of the net. And the horn sounds on an entertaining 20 minutes. Just the one goal from Colby Barlow. Team Canada coming off that win versus Germany, Slovakia. Coming off the loss versus Sweden. Coming up next in this intermission, we'll hear from Montreal Canadiens general manager Ken Hughes. Laura, Dave, standing by.
WA knows a shortcut. WA is charged up. And WA brings street smart tech along for the ride. Nobody does WAH like we do. Because at Hyundai, WAH is all we do. We make WAH.
165,
166,
167.
These burgers are exactly the same.
But this order costs more.
Doesn't make any sense. They must have miscounted.
One more time.
One more time.
One. Two. Really hungry.
Three. Keep counting. Five. Six.
I just asked.
I asked. Yeah, I asked. We just asked.
Is Ozempic right for you? Just ask your doctor or visit ozempic.ca.
Explorer looked far and wide for it. It took 200 years to find the gold.
Rookies. I can find gold online in seconds.
And gold has been a safe haven in times of turmoil.
And gold has even kept its value through inflation.
Bro, I've been there, but gold saved my portfolio. A tip for you. Visit invest.gold.
Visit invest.gold to see why gold is everyone's asset.
Oh, do you see that guy?
Yeah, I see him right there.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, good shot. Pizza's here.
Wow, that was fast.
Mmm.
So good.
I love a crispy crust.
On the cheese.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Where's your sandwich from again? No way.
So good. Open that back up. Come on.
Get 7-Eleven delivered fast or order ahead for pickup 24/7.
I've been telling everyone, the secret to great teeth is having healthy gums.
Crest Advanced Gum Restore fights plaque bacteria below the gum line, promotes gum healing, and restores gums back to health. Crest.
After scoring 46 goals with Owen Sound this season, yeah, it took Colby Barlow a couple games, but he's finally on the board here in Switzerland. Let's hear from him now with Brian.
Colby, your head coach talked about getting a great start in the game. How would you assess your opening 20 minutes?
Yeah, I thought we played hard for the most part. We had a couple of, you know, shifts in our zone, but I thought we recovered well and we got to the net, and that was a big thing for us. So it was a good first period for us.
Personally, when you score a goal, what does that do for your confidence in a long tournament like this?
Yeah, it's obviously nice to get one early here, but you know, it was a great play and just got to the net and got rewarded.
How much confidence do you take into this game after that nice bounce back performance versus Germany?
Yeah, it was an awesome bounce back by the whole group, and we just continue that confidence into today.
Good luck. Thank you.
Yeah, thanks.
Canada had the off day yesterday, a little bounce to their step in the early goings of this one. 1-0 lead over Slovakia and a perfect way to start. A terrific start for Canada, just 50 seconds in, and it was Barlow finding the back of the net.
The pace that they started the game at, they actually continued the pace through the period, especially the first 10 minutes of the period where the puck was just forced to the net constantly, and the goal is a beautiful goal. Nice play by Caden Price. He comes around the net from the point. We see it a lot. He's a great skater and slides it through the crease, and Barlow taps it in. This was talking about the way that they played in the first period. I think their mindset was, let's get pucks deep. They did it against Germany. Let's get pucks to the net. Let's get bodies to the net, and let's really put some pressure on Slovakia down low. Let's force their defense, force their goaltender to make plays down around the net. They did a great job. The first 10 minutes, they absolutely dominated. And really surprised that they didn't get more than one goal. They had 12 shots in the period, but they had plenty of great opportunities, and they should have had more, but unfortunately they only got one.
Lukas Ferschtin definitely up for the challenge here today, and Samuel Urban had started every single minute, played every minute for Slovakia, so getting a well-deserved day off today, but not really missing a beat with Ferschtin in net so far.
No, a little surprised, not really knowing what Lukas Ferschtin's all about. He's 5'10", he's a smaller goaltender, but he didn't play that way. This is first time representing Slovakia at any international tournament, but the way he played, I think they're going to invite him back. And this is a tough one, a back-to-back situation. He was very good. When there was a rebound, he usually kept them pretty close. I loved seeing this challenge in the sliding poke check. You don't see that a lot, kind of a la Dominic Hasek, the way Hasek used to come out and go for pucks. And I love the aggressiveness on that one. This one, he's not a big guy at 5'10". Like I said, he takes the low part of the net away. If you're going to score, you're going to have to get the shot away early, and you're going to have to get the shot away high. But other than the first goal, everything he saw, he challenged as well. Everything he saw, he was able to keep in front of him, and he made some really good stops in that period. Let's keep it at 1-0.
Slovakia definitely doesn't look intimidated at all playing against Canada. This tournament is a work trip for a lot of hockey brass, including Montreal Canadiens GM Ken Hughes. He'll join Brian as our intermission continues.
Gatorade. With electrolytes to help replenish what's lost in sweat. Carbs to help fuel your working muscles. And fluids to help you hydrate. Scientifically formulated so you never stop competing. Rehydrate, replenish.
That in is booming. Booyah!
Woo! Fluids to help you hydrate. Scientifically formulated so you never stop competing. Rehydrate, replenish, refuel. Gatorade. Rehydrate, replenish, refuel. Gatorade.
This is a keepsake frame. This is actually a photo from my wedding. I'm Adam Weiss, founder and CEO of Keepsake, the mobile app that makes it easy to have your photos printed, framed, and shipped to your doorstep. You just choose a photo that you love, you can preview it in over 100 frames, and in a couple of days, you're gonna receive your photo in a beautiful, handmade frame. So if you've got a special photo on your phone, install the free Keepsake app. We would love a chance to frame it for you.
Online betting is booming! Booyah!
You got new interests, a new hobby. You felt a little more adventurous. You found a bigger hobby. You explored a little more. You needed a vehicle that reflected the new you. You found it. The Toyota Corolla Cross, your new perfect.
Join the fans of Canada's game across the country and around the world and be a Hockey Canada insider. Receive news and features about Team Canada, events, promotions, and much more. Sign up at hockeycanada.ca/insider.
With Clean at Sephora, we celebrate more than what's not in our products. It's the good we put in that moves the industry forward. With nearly 100 best-in-class brands, it's a clean you can count on.
The new season is epic, with weekly themes.
New York night, 80s night, have a night.
And a new twist.
Whoa.
That will have everyone talking.
What? Somebody's messing with us.
Get into The Masked Singer, Wednesday, 8, 9 Mountain, only on CTV. Stream on all your favorite devices.
Colby Barlow is a very unique player. Because when you look at the stats, you think, oh, he's a goal scorer. No, he's much, much more than just a goal scorer. He can make plays. Even though the goals are more obvious and he's weighted towards that on the scoring totals, he can make plays. He's an excellent penalty killer. He's got speed, he's got power. He has an unbelievable ability to understand where to be to get his positioning to take shots, to penalty kill, and he has that opportunity to push his way through all the different obstacles. Opponents try and deny him, he can beat you with the speed, and he can beat you with power. And you put all those things together, and you have a player with the competitive fire that is a difference maker. Think Timo Meier, because when I watch Colby Barlow play, that's the type of player I see. And I think that that's a top-notch player. Nobody would argue that.
This year's NHL entry draft, just about 2 months away. It'll take place in Nashville as we take a look at the draft lottery odds. And of course, they're all vying for that number one pick. which is very likely going to be Connor Bedard. We've got Montreal highlighted there, coming in at 8.5%. They've got two picks coming in the first round, so you know Kent Hughes and his staff are doing their homework here in Switzerland, and here he is with Brian.
Kent, as always, really appreciate your time. I know this is a very exciting tournament for a number of reasons. A lot of work goes into this, not just this year, but years building up to a draft, of course. For you and your staff and you personally coming here, how important is that eye test so you can get a look at all these players?
I think it's, listen, we hear names all year long, and we're not able to kind of attach a game to them, so to speak, so other than watching on video. So it's nice to get see games live. I mean, it's one tournament, and we're going to trust our scouts, but it's certainly nice to be able to have the chance to see players.
What do you made of all these young players and this draft group in general?
I mean, it's a talented draft. I know, before I took this job, I coached at the 05 level for a number of years, so at least within North America, I have some familiarity with the players, so we're looking forward.
Last year was so exciting in Montreal, Juraj Slafkovský, but one particular player I want to ask about in his development was Lane Hudson. I got to watch his brother last night play for the United States. They almost look like the same player, which is crazy, right? So just talk about maybe, you know, I know you have two first-round picks, but the development of those players and just in particular Lane and his development growth this year in NCAA.
Well, he had clearly an outstanding year. I think he broke a number of scoring records for a young defenseman in college hockey. We're excited to continue to watch that development. He's a very dynamic young D. I was familiar with him because he had played at the national program, and my son was there in age up. But with COVID that year, there were so many injuries, and Lane played a lot of games up. So we're looking forward to him continuing to progress. You know, he grew. Offensively, so dynamic, so unpredictable, and we're looking forward to continuing to watch him and then eventually have him in Montreal.
Juraj Slafkovský, the first overall pick. Behind the scenes, Kent, how much work goes into, yes, you evaluate the player and then getting to know the player and the qualities that you want to draft as a Montreal Canadian?
Look, it's critical, especially in Montreal. It's not an easy market. We've got to know the hockey player, and obviously that's first and foremost, but the character and resiliency, people being able to deal with pressure and the things that come with our market, they're important to us.
We wish you luck with that lottery draft coming up on May the 8th, and thank you for joining us, and thanks for your time.
You bet. Thanks, Brad.
Day four just getting started here at the men's U18s. Canada, Slovakia, period two still to come. We've got two more games coming your way and a big one between the U.S. and Finland. That's game three of our triple header. 1 p.m. Eastern time is when our coverage gets underway. So, yes, Colby Barlow, the lone goal scorer in that opening period. Canada with the lead over Slovakia heading into the second.
Engineers don't just build things. They build solutions to make our world better. From designing treatments that give hope to those facing disease, to smarter cities that help keep our loved ones safe, they build new ways to harness renewable energy to create a better tomorrow. And they make today brighter by sparking the confidence of a young child. Because that's what engineers do. They build hope for a better future for us all. Canada's engineers, building tomorrows.
Why are these so bad?
If I would have used Kayak to book our car, we could have saved on our trip instead of during our trip.
Kayak. Search one and done.
We're going over there.
There?
There. We're going to catch a big one. Look out for the water.
Wherever you're going, whatever you're doing, do it in the most awarded SUV ever. Enjoy financing for as low as 0% for up to 60 months on Jeep Grand Cherokee.
Admit it, you use my Old Spice body wash.
I'm not letting hotel soap near my skin. They get that.
Savannah, if you don't get your moisturized hands off my body wash.
It's about more than the goals they score. It's about life skills they learn. It's about friends they make. It's about their love for hockey. None of it would be possible without the assist you can provide. The Hockey Canada Foundation Assist Fund is breaking down barriers to get Canadian youth on the ice and in the game. Every child deserves the chance to play. Donate now at hockeycanadafoundation.ca.
Here's a look at what went down in that first period. And again, Colby Barlow getting his first of the tournament just 50 seconds into the game. Let's get you back now to Brian and Craig. We've got period number two between Slovakia and Canada.
Laura, 2 p.m. local time here in Ajwa. Team Canada and Team Slovakia going head-to-head in group play. And there is your goal scorer, Colby Barlow from Orillia, Ontario. Plays for the Owenstown Attack, had great numbers there, a 46-goal season. He was fifth in goals in the Ontario Hockey League in the regular season. And a big goal, Craig, to get Team Canada on the board there in the first.
I didn't recognize Colby earlier today. He shaved off his beard. He's trying to go a little incognito, I think. But, he's been a really good player here for Canada. He does everything in the game. He forechecks, he skates, he can shoot the puck, he kills penalties. I mean, he's just a really well-rounded player. And certainly him scoring, he's had some good chances, just lifts a little bit of the weight off your shoulders and you don't have to press as much.
So Mason McTavish's beard or his before he shaved it? I mean, these are two men playing in an under-18 tournament.
Mason never shaved his beard at the under-18. He never thought about doing that. But
Mason McTavish, outstanding player. He won a gold in Texas for Canada a few years ago, and you saw Colby Barlow leading all forwards for Canada in ice time, nearly 20 minutes per game, and he's got Canada on the board. As we're all set here for this second period, Slovakia, Canada trying to get back on the podium for the first time since 2021, missing the mark last year, losing to Finland in the quarterfinals. So underway in the second, here's Celebrini in the offensive zone. He'll backhand it in for Richie. Sturback there, picked up by Matthew Wood. Wood, Celebrini spinning, and that was off Espriessi, and it'll deflect out of play.
The two teammates with the Chicago Steel, Espriessi. There is the goaltender, Lucas Fursten, who had a couple of close moments in that first period, including one on Celebrini, where good race for the puck, and Celebrini couldn't quite get it over him, over the outstretched arms and body of Thurston.
Slovakia, if you don't know the story, relegated back in Sweden in 2019. And back in the big tournament and try to make an impact. As is Juraj Pešek, a little bit of space, cutting in. Couldn't get the shot away, but a penalty coming up, and it's a penalty shot. So a penalty shot coming up here for Slovakia.
So Canada wins the faceoff in the offensive zone, and Matthew Wood was on the puck, but it's kind of up on the edge, and that allows Pekarsik to get off to the races. And, it's one of those unfortunate plays. Dalibor Dvorsky is going to take the penalty shot.
What an opportunity here for Slovakia. Dalibor Dvorsky has already played in two World Juniors and trying to pull Slovakia into a spot in the quarters. Here he comes, Dvorsky, in on Bjarnason. Dvorsky, forehand, and he missed. He missed the mark.
He had no mark to hit because Bjarnason played it perfectly. Bjarnason pushed him there. His positioning, his posture, his stance was outstanding. And as Dvorsky's trying to look for an opening, he saw one, and now he's pushing to that side of the ice, and he's trying to hit a spot that the only spot he was going to hit was wide of the net because Bjarnason gave him nothing. That's just outstanding patience and poise by Bjarnason. And excellent move by Bjarnason, or excellent patience by Bjarnason.
Huge stop in the context of the game as Canada still leads just a few seconds into the second. Barlow racing on Baran. Height will pump it back in. They got to get back onside, and they weren't, so Height will have to do it one more time.
And that was an unfortunate play for Matthew Wood. That puck just got off on end, and he just couldn't corral it. It wasn't a turnover, but ends up becoming a very close call, and Bjarnason did his part.
2-on-1. Here comes Height leading the rush. Flips it across, and Barlow shut down again by Fursten, who's having a great game for Slovakia. Canada controls. Moved across for Price. He's got space. Walks it in. Shoots off a stick and just wide. And Height was creeping in, looking for that rebound. As that hit the air at stick, allowing Pekarsik to dangle in. Look out. Backhand flip as Pekarsik nearly took that all the way to the house. Entertaining start here to this second period. Tanner Howell. He'll cut in for Team Canada. Played in Regina this year. Teammate, line mate of Connor Bedard. As that shot from Gibson misses. Bertucci able to hold the line. High floater. Barlow, that might have been a high stick as he knocks it down and nearly converted. That would have been a close call. Good hand high by Barlow. He'll head off for a change.
It would have been a high stick. There would have been no goal.
Catton tries the centering pass. That'll be cleaned up, moved up ice. As Kuchenberg starting the play, goes to the net. Kuchenberg trying to knock that down and get a shot away. Kuchenberg continues to work, gets the puck back. Trying to spin away from Lardis. Bertucci able to settle it down and clear. Here's McDonough. McDonough with the Bertucci going to the net. Here comes Catton trying to break through. Tangled up enough by Stanislav Grahn. Bertucci over across Lardis. One time drive and he missed.
Canada's been really good at moving the puck quickly out of their own zone. Something they did very poorly against Sweden. They've really picked that part of their game up. So this comes real quick. Bjarnason whips it up the boards and there's a little chip by Howe. And here goes Riley Height and he just feathers it over to Barlow. Good read by Thurston though. And Thurston lays right out. Gets the blocker there. Some good goaltending. And then there's the high stick. Yeah, that's a high, high stick.
He's at Eno Chara high. Face off to the right of Bjarnason. Controlled by Slovakia. Stravlovic shot it. Didn't get through. Good shot block. And McDonnell up for Haliburta. He'll chip it in. Canada getting some fresh legs out. Burns watched by Ridzon. Ridzon pins in. Good pass in front as Parsika trying to get that in front. Dragosevic took it away.
And for Team Canada, this Slovakia team is not going away. We saw that against Sweden. They know how to stay in a game. They know how to take advantage when they get some opportunities. So Canada's going to have to stay right on task because this is a tough opponent.
Burns with a wrist shot. You know, Lucas first, and full credit to him. We thought Samuel Urban would be the guy as he had a really strong start to the tournament. But first, and the 17-year-old, 5'10", standing tall in net.
Yeah, and, you know, the coach puts him in there. I was shocked to see Samuel Urban not starting, but certainly Thurston has played very well. Somebody else that has played very, very well here after getting off a plane from Canada has been Riley Height.
Woods on the puck, right in front for Richie. Score! Callum Richie buries 1-2-0 Canada.
They call that face-off ready. And, you know, we saw the play earlier that led to the penalty shot. Matthew Wood was face-off ready. And just a bad bounce. This is face-off ready. Jumping into the play. There's Wood again getting it. Richie getting right over to the front of the net and just sliding it behind Thurston. The puck gets dropped. Everybody has to know what the task is and read the play. Wood on the puck. Richie to the front of the net. 2-0 Canada. Just superbly done.
Callum Richie with his second of the tournament. He led the Hlinka Gretzky team, winning gold and scoring, and he now leads this team right now in scoring. 2 goals, 5 points for Callum Richie.
What a beautiful pass by Matthew Wood as well.
And Canada was pushing, and that is a big goal to get a little bit more breathing room in a game they have to have versus Slovakia. As Canada, their sights set here on second in the group. Wood read it to center ice, picked off by Pekarsik. Wood able to settle it down. Celebrini for Wood, the give and go, and he was driving in. Wood gets taken down by Buran, and first it holds.
Jonathan Toews was such a complete player. And, you know, I'm very careful about talking about comparable types, but Macklin Celebrini, that little play he just makes there with his stick, every time I watch him, I'm even more convinced that his game replicates in terms of style, in terms of full two-way play, complete player of that of Jonathan Toews. And this is a young, young player that plays with that type of maturity and that type of understanding.
He's committed to Boston University. We're already 4 minutes into the second. Kravlovic throws that cross ice, nobody home. Kuchenberg in the corner. Kuchenberg continues to battle for the puck. Cleaned up by Team Canada. Nice little chip to Barlow up that right wing. Colby Barlow waits, pulls the trigger. Good shot right on. Follow-up try as, again, Lucas Firston was ready. Canada maintains possession. Just held onside by Gibson as he jumped on the ice. He'll drop it back. Riley Height towards the net. Howe shoots off a leg and wide. Riley Height arriving yesterday. Nice team dinner yesterday for the day off for Team Canada. Good chance to continue to bond and get a little tighter as a group. Howe lost it in his skates. Tobizo at center ice. He'll work it in with Parika tracking in as well. Yakimchuk, stretch pass. Howe, little touch for Haliburton. Trying to spin around Sturback. Play to center ice. There's Gibson. Gibson will sling that across. Yakimchuk in his own zone. Bobizel, good job to break that up momentarily. Haliburton takes contact far boards. There's Alex Frand. He'll find it, shoot it in. Alex Frand, another player that has impressed Jeff Truitt this tournament. Sedzo hit by Dragosevic. Sedzo looking for any help, can't find it. And as for Jesse, he will play to Sturback.
Such a good play there. Canada's making a line change, and then Slovakia goes up and posts up at the far blue line trying to make that long play. You got to be ready when you come out on the ice to size up the situation. Lucas Dragosevic does a really nice job of that.
Brand in front looking for Crystal. Crystal couldn't find it, and Haliburton loads up. And first had got enough. Burns sends it across. Dragosevic. He'll lock it in. Dragosevic. Below the goal line. Towards the net, throws one, looking for the tip, and there was bodies in front. Haliburton and Crystal, good job to provide that screen. Haliburton into the corner. Crystal leaves it. That's for Jesse there. Haliburton into the battle. Dragosevic decides to pinch, and he'll chip it in again for Canada. Good pressure, thrown in front for Haliburton, and he just missed the redirect. Great shift here by Canada, changing on the fly. Dragosevic, and sensing things heating up for Canada, Lucas Firston's going to shut that down. 2-0, Canada leads.
The latest chapter in the history of women's sports, the debut of the WNBA.
The first ever WNBA All-Star game.
What's he going to do?
Absolutely. There's number 1,000 in her WNBA career.
I was born here, I'm from here, and I'm never leaving here. I'm a New York hotel. Yeah, I'm tall. 563 feet and 2 inches. I'm on top of the world. I'm looking for someone who needs a weekend in the city, who likes being in the middle of it all. You hungry? I know a place. And a few others nearby. It's the city that never sleeps. But hey, if you need a last-minute spot, I've got you covered. Let's link up at hotels.com.
Barlow adds a lot of attributes to a game, and one of them is heavy hockey. He plays heavy. There's good physical play, pushing players off the puck, making sure that he lets them know that I'm in the play and you're going to have to deal with me. And he's quick, and he's got real power in his skating, and we know how good he is offensively, but you think about when the games get hard, and whether it be World Championship, certainly the Stanley Cup playoffs. We talked about heavy and hard hockey. Colby Barlow, he fits the bill for what teams want to see come playoff time.
Crystal on the puck, flips it up for Price. Allen, wrist shot, tip, bouncing puck. High slot, comes into the corner. Price against Borsinet and just wide. Good hustle by Allen, holds it in. Price. He'll skate in. Price still with it. Caden Price trying to get it in front. Pekarsik can't clear. Price for Catton. Catton walks it in. Oh, he had McDonnell cruising in. Couldn't get the puck on his stick. Slovakia. And again, Pekarsik had a little bit of runway. Couldn't get to the puck in time. Dej in the corner. Dej, Pekarsik, and Jenko was there as well. Chromiak loads up the wrist shot. Goes to the right of Bjarnason. Slovakia trying to find a little push here, and Lardis able to flip that to center ice. Knocked down. And this time cleared to center ice by Team Canada.
When you try to feather pucks in and around the offensive net softly, you're just playing with danger. Teams are too good at knocking those plays down and then transitioning. We just saw it with Berkeley Cat. Perfect example of he's got a shooting spot. He's right there and he wants to feather it across, knock down other way. It's not a good play. And I see it at the NHL level. I see it at the NHL level. I see it, you know, it's just one of those things that just, you can't be soft in that area.
And what exactly did Jeff Truitt tell us right before this game? Those are the type of plays that he wanted to eliminate. You know, let's go north-south. The east-west stuff, the soft stuff, the little passes, exactly what he wanted to eliminate going forward.
Well, we talk about the blue lines, the neutral zone, but it's also in that spot.
Matthew Wood along the boards. He's headed for Richie. Kuchenberg in transition quickly. Kuchenberg worked it across. Gets it back. Kuchenberg trying to get the shot away. Stripped of the puck. Celebrini over the line. Trying to cut by Skirback, the captain, and he read that well. Callum Ritchie looking for an opportunity. Bertucci poking at the puck. Bouncing right in front of both benches. In comes Ritchie. A little bit of space. Drops. Celebrini just out of the reach of Wood. He'll keep the play alive. Ritchie in front. And that was poked away by Espriesi. Maxime Sturback. Espriesi up ahead for Cesar. Cesar brings it in. Haliburta. He'll clean it up that right side, and he's on the move for Team Canada. Haliburta, wrist shot, blocked. Ridzon, banned on the clearing attempt. Turnover, Haliburta trying to get it in front. Burns stepping up in a big-time check. That one on Bobizil. Puck into the corner. Ferran just through his legs. Sedzo skates it up ice for Slovakia. Kravlovic, he lost it. There's Martone. Stretch pass. Oh, he had Haliburta. Better stick, though, by Pioza, who took that breakaway chance away. Another stretch pass, though. Up ahead. Martone. Little hot move. Passes back. Frand. Height. Riley Height through the legs. And 2-on-2 the other way. Dvorsky cuts in. Poked away by Dragosivic. Dvorsky around the boards. Works it in deep for Sedzo. Sedzo trying to center, and Allen took it away. Cam Allen, he'll shoot it in for Team Canada. Burstyn out to play it, high off the glass. There's Tanner Howe, he'll backhand it in. For Chromiak on the puck, tries to deliver it out. Good effort there to keep it in by Height. Nsika, a little shot, handled by Bjarnason. Not a lot on it, Dvorsky. Dvorsky brings it up to the line. Bursic works it down low. Tough angle shot handled by Bjarnason. He was ready from the drive by Jenko.
He was. He stayed right on that post and upright. There was no room for Jenko to get it into the net.
Pass in front for Barlow. Barlow tries to get backhand follow-up. Rebound try, and he flipped it. Three good chances again for Colby Barlow in tight. Here's Price. Walks the line. Wrist shot. Tip just wide. Heights in front. Tries that backhand for Howe. Tanner Howe. Up for Bertucci. Tristan Bertucci works it across. Wrist shot now is tipped again just wide. Good bodies and sticks in front by Team Canada. And Lucas Burston, he's having a quality game for Slovakia, keeping them alive.
Knowing that Riley Height, you know, just finished a playoff series up in Prince George, getting on a plane, traveling all the way over here, I have been so impressed with his energy and how well he has played here. Not surprised that he could do it, but just under the circumstances.
Shot in front, Larnes jamming away, the puck's still loose, and it was still loose, but you heard the whistle as Canada pressing for goal number three here in Oshawa.
Domino's, mix and match any two or more pizzas and sides for just $8.99 each. Like when pizza night's more like pizza and lava cakes night, or pasta and stuffed cheesy bread night, or we're gonna need a bigger table night. Mix and match Canada's favorite pizza and more at Domino's.
Price alerts saved me an immense amount of time.
Time is money. You just sit back and wait for the app to tell you.
I can get notifications just to be able to know when that vehicle that I want is within my reach.
RS is more than a style. It's a mindset where bold choices are the norm and style matters. It's a reminder, whatever you do, keep it RS. Introducing the 2023 Chevrolet Equinox RS and Blazer RS. Discover yours and keep it RS. Find new style, find new roads.
Well, Colby Barlow has a goal in this game, and he's had a number of really good chances. There's one on the backhand, hunting two, and then he tries to flip it up and over. A hat trick of chances. And Berkeley Catton earlier is trying to make a feather play where he comes right back, and that's where you take the puck. Put it right into the net. Don't try to make those feather plays in and around the net. Defenders are too good. Just a reminder that. There's another example where, you know, he's looking to make a play. Sometimes your best play is right to the net with the puck.
Kuchenberg and wrist shot clubbed down by Carson Bjarnason.
Well, Jeff Truitt has left no doubt what his belief level is in Carson Bjarnason. And when you consider now, after being pulled after five goals against Sweden, he's come back in, no goals through one and a half games here.
Bjarnason was a defenseman growing up as a kid, and then around 13 years of age became a goalie. It's like a pretty good decision. Now representing Team Canada. Undrafted in the NWHL Bantam Draft, his second season in Brandon in his home province. He's from Carberry, Manitoba. Pretty good with the guitar, I understand. He played music growing up. A little bit of fishing to relax. Be honest, it's exactly what I like to do, too. He's not old enough for the red wine yet. He's 17, but it's really cool to get to know the personalities and the players behind the masks at these tournaments. And he'll leave it there for Dragosivic. Dragosivic will throw it up for Burns. Burns up the left side with Wood. Work down low for Celebrini. Celebrini takes the cross check behind the net. There's big Matthew Wood, 6'3". He'll free it up top. Dragosivic for Burns. Burns, quick wrister. That was stopped by Furston. Shift to the line, there's Dvorsky. Dvorsky throws the backhand in for Sedzo. Dragosivic there first, Sedzo hits him. Chipped up by Celebrini, diving to make the play and try to jam it up ahead. And the hand goes up, tripping the call, so a tripping penalty coming up, and it'll be Slovakia on the power play.
It was a loose puck along the boards in the neutral zone, and Celebrini was trying to find a way to push the puck forward, and then he gets a stick in the feet of his teammate with the Chicago Steel, Leo Eperjesi. That's where the penalty gets called. right here, pulling him down.
Off the draw, Slovakia controls. Sturback in. Rister, traffic in front. Bjarnason's got to fight through and find it. He does, with Kukenberg right there providing the screen.
Well, he fights through it, and then he makes sure that he knows where that puck is. Not an easy play for a goaltender, because the play's coming in, and there's lots of traffic there. He finds the puck, and then he finds it a second time. So you got to have a real good focus on the play and how it's unfolded, and then a real good understanding of what you're trying to do with that shot. Carson Bjarnason just superb in both regards.
Sturback at the line. Sturback delays for Jenko. Jenko, wrist shot off the stick of Allen and out of play.
Remember, we saw Slovakia get back into the game versus Sweden on the power play, and certainly this is another opportunity. You know, we saw the penalty shot. Dvorsky wasn't able to finish, and now with another opportunity with the score 2-0, trying to find a way to inch their way back into this one as well.
Sturback, nice little move around McDonnell. He'll skate it in himself. Sturback around the boards for Dish. Dish hit by Martone. Martone from a knee, trying to clear. Sedso keeps it in. Dish spinning away from traffic. Sedso up for Sturback. Jenko, one-time drive, and the good push across by Bjarnason. He'll squeeze.
Perfect by Carson Bjarnason.
A little bit of pushing after the play. And Kukenberg, he's in a conversation at the other side there with Mesnika.
Yeah, Carson Bjarnason, just the quiet feet, the understanding of how this play is unfolding, and then just moving over there perfectly, and no rebound. And Jenko can shake his head in wonderment, but when the goaltender is a half a step ahead of you, he's going to have to make a big mistake for you to score a goal. Carson Bjarnason wasn't making that mistake.
Right now they have five skaters out for Team Canada, so someone has to head off. And on the way off, Allen is having a chat with the entire bench of Slovakia. So face off. Outside of the zone, Howe able to win it. Good clear by Team Canada. Colby Barlow watching things over. Sturback, drop pass. Barlow was ready for that. He finds it, intercepts, and flips it back in with Howe cruising in. Sturback in his own zone. Under 6 minutes to go here in the second. Sturback will drop it back. Dvorsky up that left side. And again, a good, strong play from Canada, doing solid work on the penalty kill. Latest work from Yakimchuk, the steal and the clear. And Slovakia will try one more time, led by Dvorsky. Dvorsky will backhand it in, but he gave it away. Mesnika stops. Tried to work it in deep, and McDonnell, the flip up ahead. Here's a chance. Porter Martone into the forehand, score! What a move! Porter Martone, shorthanded goal, and Canada is up by 3.
Nice move by Porter Martone to finish it, but Angus McDonnell in the middle of it again, and just feathers it beautifully to the streaking Martone, and just Thurston laying all out, Thurston laying as out as best as he can, and Martone just slips it by him as he's sliding away from the net. Just a really nice, confident move, and yeah, that's one to celebrate. His second goal of the tourney. Celebrini giving a little stick tap. But you know, know, one of the things Jeff Truitt and the coaching staff tries to emphasize with the players is your positioning. You know, sometimes, you know, you have this thought that you want to move, but sometimes where you're at is right where you need to be. And Angus McDonnell is a perfect example of that. Play gets broken up. He's in the right spot. It's 3-0 Canada.
Callum Ritchie has Team Canada back to even strength, and a shorthanded goal by Martone. Pride of Peterborough, Ontario. Burns, wrist shot, deflected. Good pad save first and was ready. Celebrini. Tenacious back on the puck. Works it for Ritchie. Ritchie. Quick shot, and Celebrini was looking corner, and he didn't miss by much. Beautiful short-handed goal from Porto Martone.
Ray Magliozzi here. eBay Motors has millions of parts. Hey, Dave?
Yep. Wait.
How are those new wipers?
They're small.
For parts that fit your vehicle, go to eBay Motors. Let's ride.
How do we know you'll love pretzel crust pizza from Little Caesars? Well, with a creamy cheddar cheese sauce, pepperoni, and a soft salted pretzel outer edge, pretzel crust pizza tastes like no other. So, yeah, we think you'll love it with a burning pretzel passion.
Delivery, delivery.
Hockey fans, get your Hockey Canada gear at shop.hockeycanada.ca. The official online store of Hockey Canada and the largest selection of Hockey Canada gear anywhere. Get jerseys, men's and women's tees, hoodies, headwear, and more. Don't miss out. Shop now and get today's special offer. Shop.hockeycanada.ca, a Fanatics experience.
Well, Porter Martone just makes a brilliant move here as he's moving from right to left and then the stick between the legs and just pushes it back past the outstretched left leg of Furston. And never a good spot for the goaltender to be laying flat on his belly trying to make a save. Usually that's a bad position to be in if you're a goalie.
In comes Burns, tried to drag it in. High flip to center ice, under five to go here in this second period. Martone not draft eligible till 2025. Underage player for Canada this tournament. Dragosivan chips into the corner. Pioja tries to keep it moving. Play to the line. Burns fakes the shot. Holds it in. Wrister up high. Hit Bristol in front. Good shot by Lard as he's trying to jam it in from behind the goal line. And Slovakia coming in numbers. He'll dump it in. Braun. In on the forecheck with Cesar. Cesar gets dropped in the corner. Rizon, though, picks that off. Rizon, wrist shot up high. And a good piece by Bjarnason. Rebound was available, but it's cleared down the ice by Canada. And here comes Crystal. Crystal walking it in. Back pass. McDonnell still loose. Jamming for it. Tries again. And it's in the legs and then cleared as Furston thought about coming out to gamble. He saw Crystal coming in and he retreated back into his net.
Yeah, the stop and start, or the start and stop by Furston. And right now, Andrew Crystal, who's a really good offensive player, he just doesn't look real offensively confident. Like it's like the plays are moving a little bit slower than you're accustomed to seeing him play. And
Marlow, one-time drive, he just missed wide.
Face-off ready again, though. Really good plays by Canada off the face-offs in the offensive zone.
Good turnover, and Gibson, opportunistic off the steal. Good stop by Furston.
You know, John Dean, the assistant coach with Team Canada, who coaches Andrew Gibson up with the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds, you know, one of the things, too, when you have a coach here who's coached a player, and now you can work with him, you can tell the other coaches, hey, listen, you know, I know how to make sure to get him calmed down. And we're seeing that progression in the defense play. More assertive, more confident, more decisive, not only in the offensive zone, but in the defensive zone, and moving the puck quick, and certainly essential elements for success for any team.
Andrew Gibson from Windsor, Ontario. Mesnika didn't like what he saw. Drops it off in the corner. Said so. He takes contact. Dvorsky. If a line's going to score, this is the line for Slovakia that'll try to get it done. Sedzo, contact, Dvorsky. Dvorsky, space, walks it in. Dvorsky, still delay, shoot, score! Dalibor Dvorsky gets one by Bjarnason, and Slovakia on the board here in Switzerland. It's 3-1.
Slovakia knows how to stay in the game. They know they're going to be determined to try to find their way back into the game, and there's no better way of doing that. A really good play by Dvorsky to create the turnover and keep the puck in, and then he moves right across the middle of the ice and shoots it back the other way. Just an excellent play by Dvorsky. First, without the puck, creating when the puck is on his stick, showing off his lateral agility and a really nice shot inside the post to get Slovakia on the board.
Dvorsky doesn't turn 18 till 15th. He played in the Hockey Allsvenskan, the second men's division in Sweden this year. 6 goals, 14 points in 38 games, and that is a big-time goal in this game for Slovakia.
97 minutes of 31 shutout play for Carson Bjarnason.
Dej in the corner, using his frame, trying to muscle that puck free. 2 minutes remaining here in the second period. Moran fires it back in. There's Price. Round the boards for Allen, the captain. Big body check right in front of the bench, and Haliburta took the brunt of that. Price jams it along the wall. Sturback, head up, he'll play it along the boards. Comes to center ice, picked up by Allen. Allen for Fran. He'll send that the length of the ice. Dragusevic, he'll leave it. That wrist shot high off the stick, and no one saw the puck, and with the flex out of play.
Minute 24 here left. We saw it against Sweden, and Canada has to be prepped for it. But Slovakia, they're going to compete. And they're going to force you into spots. They're not going to wait, sit back. So for Canada, you have to keep pressing and being smart with your efforts, especially with the puck, because Slovakia knows how to put you into bad spots. And then they try to take advantage, and that's exactly what they did against Sweden and getting back to 3-3.
Well, we talked about the draft with Kent Hughes during the intermission. What a draft it was for Slovakia, and Kent taking two of those players, Juraj Slavkovsky and Filip Mešar, in the first round. It was Nemec going second overall, Slavkovsky first. So real renaissance of this program as well, being elevated to the top tournament again and giving teams really good tests, including Sweden, including Canada. Final minute here, second period in Ajwa. In a 3-1 game, Canada, can they strike late? Pass in front, intercepted, intended for Ritchie. Kuchenberg delivers that across. Good stick by Burns. He broke that up nicely. Ritchie, Wood cutting in. Matthew Wood delays. Sedzo diving back. Canada still controls. Flipped up top. Wrist shot, and that was stopped. Yakimchuk, good velocity, and Fersten was ready. Entertaining second period between Slovakia and Canada. 10 seconds remaining. Stretch pass for Haliburta. He'll shoot it in. Fersten out to settle it down. In comes Fran. Haliburta towards the net. Bouncing puck. Just a second remaining, and there's the horn. So some life from Slovakia, courtesy Dvorsky, as he makes it a 3-1 game. Goals for Canada, Barlow, Ritchie, and the shorthanded goal from Martone. So coming up in our intermission, Red Wings general manager Steve Yzerman will join Craig Button in the booth as we step aside from Ajwa. Your intermission is coming up next. Laura Dykin, Dave Reed.
The Jeep No Limits event is here, which means more trails to blaze, more challenges to meet, more sights to discover. Get into a Jeep Wrangler, the most capable Wrangler ever. Or Jeep Grand Cherokee, the most awarded SUV ever. Jeep No Limits is here. Time to test your limits. Right now, finance the Jeep Grand Cherokee for as low as 0% for up to 60 months.
It's time to print. Get an additional $20 when you purchase a $100 prepaid print card. Printing done right every time. Can saving be easy?
Let's find out.
EGO, the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power, brings you the Select Cut Mower. Customize the cut with three interchangeable blades. It cuts for over an hour on a single charge. Find an EGO retailer near you.
Summer is a perfect time to see the Yukon. The midnight sun just never sets. Well, maybe for like 10 minutes, but then it's back. So you can hike these huge mountains, camp overnight. It's unbelievable.
I'm the butcher.
I'm the baker.
I'm the candlestick maker.
I'm the welder.
The climber.
The jewelry designer.
The dentist.
The cook.
The author of a book.
The beekeeper.
The trainer.
The circus entertainer.
Whatever you make, however you make it, let's make it together. Linaris, proud partner of Canadian business.
From affordable housing and employment to mental health and newcomer services, every year, Woodgreen meets the unmet needs of 37,000 Torontonians. Donate at woodgreen.org.
The Tim's app makes your Tim's run faster and easier. Order ahead to avoid the line. Plus, use the new Scan and Pay feature to pay, earn, and redeem points with just one scan. Download the Tim's app today.
You saved your life.
The odds aren't good enough for me.
Then better the odds.
We will work as a team and figure it out.
The Good Doctor, Monday only on CTV. Stream on all your favorite devices.
Canada with a pair of goals there in that second period. Callum Ritchie got the scoring started for Team Canada. He's joined now with our Brian Mudrick.
Callum, you knew that Slovakia would play you guys tough despite that late goal by them in the second. What have you made of your team's effort thus far?
Yeah, it's obviously good. I think we just have to stick to our structure and play hard here. I think we can dictate if we win or not. So for the top of our game, I think this game should get out of hand.
You have experience with Team Canada. Offensively, you've been contributing. Personally, where's your confidence level right now?
Yeah, I know it's high. It's a lot of fun playing with these guys, and you get confidence from playing with great players like that. And it's a lot of fun, and hopefully we can get this win.
How much has Bjarnason made an impact on this team?
Yeah, he's an unreal goalie. I mean, you notice in practice, especially in games too. So he's a great guy off the ice as well. So he's been unreal for us this game.
Critical details to close this thing out in the third.
Pardon?
Critical things maybe you want to work on in the third to try close this game out.
Yeah, I think we just have to play our game. We can't get selfish and try to toe drag at the blue line and stuff like that. We have to get pucks in and limit turnovers. So if we do those things, I think we'll get the win.
Callum, really appreciate your time. Good luck.
Thank you.
Callum has been giving them plenty to cheer about lately. He had a goal and three assists against Germany and keeping it going here today, scoring Canada's first goal of that second period. Dave and Laura back with you once again. We're going to start things off here in this intermission with Slovakia, and a big strength of this team coming into this game was their play on the power play. Four of their five goals they've scored so far this tournament on the man advantage. Hasn't been as successful this game, so what's kind of flipped the script here a little bit for Slovakia?
Well, Canada's done a nice job of clogging up the neutral zone, and on the shorthanded goal by Porter Marton, Slovakia had four opportunities to gain the zone and were unable to do so. This drop pass, every team does it, but if you don't execute it, it's a tough giveaway. So there's number one. The second is you get into the zone and you try to force the play through a defenseman's stick and feet. That doesn't work. The third one, carried in. This is Dvorsky, who did get the goal to get the donut off the board, so to speak, but he gives the puck away. The fourth one, this is where Canada capitalizes it. Angus MacDonald picks his puck up,
and finds Martone, and it's a beautiful finish by Porter Martone. The four of the five goals that Slovakia scored coming in were on the power play, like I said, Laura. Their fifth goal, their third one against Sweden, was actually 8 seconds after the power play. So all of their goals until the Dvorsky goal had been generated either on the power play or just because of the power play.
For Canada, contributions up and down the lineup so far here today. With their goals, though, they've got three of them, as we've kind of highlighted one of them already. You've kind of noticed a theme with them.
Lateral movement. If you're as struggling as back and forth, if you're struggling to score and you're dominating a team such as this game is going with the shots 17-9 in the period, all three goals are getting the goaltender, Lucas Fersten, to move. Nice play by Matthew Wood on the faceoff to Richie in the first period. In the second period, this is the goal. The first period is a similar type of play, except it was Caden Price goes around. He tries to jam, and it's Colby Barlow. The key to this goal, shorthanded goal by Martone, is he reverses the way he's going with the puck. You think he's going on the backhand. He makes a real nice play, pull the puck between the legs, and go the opposite direction. You've got to get your goaltender moving laterally. Canada's been dominant in this game of putting pucks to the net, creating chances. But they've only had a couple of opportunities where they've moved the puck laterally, and three of those chances have resulted in goals. We'll see if they continue that in the third period.
Canada was starting to pull away a little bit there, and Slovakia keeping everything in check. 3-1 your score after 40 minutes. And as our intermission continues, the guests keep on coming. Next up, Red Wings Executive Vice President and General Manager Steve Yzerman will join Craig in the booth.
When Payne says, "It's time to go home," I say, "Not yet." Aleve, who do you take it for?
If you own an RV, you could be making thousands of dollars every month by renting it out on RVZ.com.
While your renters are making memories, you're making money. If you're not using it, RVZ. Go to RVZ.com today.
Fellow elites, now that we've made travel so ridiculously expensive, we can enjoy this hotel without all the filthy normals littering this place with their mindless frivolity. How'd you get here?
Kayak. Huh? They compared hundreds of travel sites to find a great deal on my flight, car, and hotel.
I guess we'll just have to eat him. Yuck. You do it.
Kayak. Search one and done.
Gosh, I look young there.
The first ever Legends trading card packs are at Tim's now. Collect them all.
I'll trade one of you for one of me.
Online betting is booming. Booyah! Woo! Oh, yeah! You can win big! But you could also lose. There is risk with online gambling, and that's a reality nobody's shouting about. Learn about safer play at knowtherisks.ca.
EGO, the number one rated brand in cordless outdoor power, brings you the Select Cut mower, built to exceed the power of gas. Customize the cut with EGO's revolutionary dual blade cutting system with three interchangeable blades. Featuring EGO's patented lithium battery technology, it cuts for over an hour on a single charge. And touch drive self-propelled technology makes it effortless. The EGO Power Plus Select Cut mower. Find an EGO retailer near you.
The countdown is on to this year's NHL draft at the end of June in Nashville. And as you can see, the Red Wings will be busy as five of the first 42 picks will be going Detroit's way. With more now, let's hear from Steve Yzerman as he's joined with our Craig Button.
You come over here, Steve, and you really got your scouting cap on. You've done it for a number of years, and you got a lot of good young players. So when you're coming over to watch the players and then you select them, how do you balance that potential, the fans' thirst to get young players into the lineup, and making sure that they get in there when they're ready?
Well, we all want them there sooner than later. You know, it just really takes a lot of patience, I think, allow and I just allow them time to be physically ready to play, and I guess mentally ready for that matter. It's you throw them into the lineup too early, they can struggle, lose confidence, and take it's a step backwards. So for the most part, we let them excel at whether it's junior and college hockey in European leagues, and when they're ready to come over to North America or ready to play in the American League or the NHL, you move them up. So there's no real set strategy to it all. Just kind of watch them play and see them in training camp, preseason, and if you think they're ready to go, you put them in.
The younger players have a little bit more impatience these days, a little bit more thirst to get there sooner rather than later?
Well, I think all young players do. Probably back when we played back in the day, all want to get to the NHL as soon as possible. I think what is different now, you have access to so much more information, I guess, and a lot of it is false information and it's misleading, so you just get thinking you're more ready than you actually are, and based on what you read, we all got to read, write good articles and write things to get people's attention, and it can be misleading for the kids. So yeah, I think they all have maybe higher expectations.
Well, you have a really good young team in Detroit. Lots of really good top-notch prospects are going to make up a big part of your team and what it takes to have success. The division in the Atlantic, it's been Boston, Tampa Bay where you were, Toronto, but now your team, Ottawa, Buffalo Sabres,
Montreal's coming with a lot of good kids.
Yeah, I don't want to forget, but so like, do you see that excitement coming back for the fan base in Detroit and the excitement of young players being able to push a team further ahead?
Probably every team says it, but we're in a tough division. One that the top teams are really good, and I think for the foreseeable future, their nucleuses are really strong and expect them to continue. And then you look at Buffalo and Ottawa, the young players they've got in their lineup. It's like, whoa, they're going to get better and be they're primed for a good, solid run here in the next 10 years. And us in Montreal building a little bit behind them. So it's always a challenge. You face different challenges and you just kind of stick with it. But our fan base has been fantastic in Detroit. In the last couple of years, they've seen some of the younger players come into the lineup. I still consider Dylan Larkin our captain as a young player, and as you start to move some of these kids in, the fan base gets hope. And, hockey in Detroit is a big sport. Obviously, the Red Wings have been around since the 20s. It's a popular sport in the state of Michigan. So people are pretty knowledgeable. And they see the young kids coming in, and they're starting to see some hope that there's a bit of a nucleus being formed. Explain that it's just, unfortunately, it's just going to continue to take a while to build that strong nucleus or deeper nucleus.
Yeah, well, every reason to be encouraged. Thank you for joining us.
My pleasure, Craig. Thank you.
Here, Steve and Craig talk hockey all day, but we have a third period to get to in Canada, holding on to that 2-goal lead over Slovakia.
Sunset Marigold?
Your call. I'm better at sorting out our mortgage, which was super easy with RBC. They paired us with our own mortgage specialist to give us helpful advice and our best rate.
Boom. Get up to $3,500 and 55,000 Avion points with an RBC mortgage.
When you stay at Vrbo, you always get the whole home. Not part of it, but the whole upstairs. The whole downstairs. The whole fridge and the whole secret nap room. Because is it really a vacation home if you have to share the house with the host? Only with Vrbo.
At the Nissan Institute of Thrillology, we make sure the road gets your motor running. An excellent performance in performance. Technology passes with flying colors. And confidence that's off the charts. The Nissan Rogue. Thrillology approved.
During the Nissan Test at the Thrill event, lease a 2023 Rogue from $99 weekly for only 24 months. It's the most
wonderful time of the year. Non-drowsy Claritin provides 24-hour relief from symptoms caused by indoor and outdoor allergens. Feel the clarity and make today the most wonderful time of the year. Live Claritin Clear.
know Craig and Brian have already touched on this, but Slovakia trailed 3-1 to Sweden a couple days ago, heading into the third before making things interesting. You know, the coaches and players on both sides are aware of that. Let's get you back to Craig and Brian now and the call of the third period.
Close to 3 p.m. local time here in Ajwa as the under-18 World Hockey Championship continues in Switzerland as we're back here for the first time since 2015 and Team Canada 3-1 advantage.
I think Jeff Truitt would have liked Callum Ritchie's interview with you during that second intermission where when you asked him what they have to do and he said no toe drags at the blue lines. I think Jeff will go, way to go, Callum. That's the right answer. So no, hey, listen, there's certain things that are always going to be essential to winning, and you don't want to put yourself into a vulnerable spot, and managing the puck, understanding how quickly teams can take advantage of a turnover in different spots. You know, we hear the term north-south, that, you know, don't go east-west, and I think that that's really important here. Slovakia doesn't come into this third period think, oh, let's hold, let's see what we can happen. They're going to press, so Canada now has to continue what has been a very strong game for them here in the third period to close it up.
Head coach Tibor Tortel, Slovakia, two medals all time in this tournament, 1999 bronze, a silver in 2003, Canada, eight medals all time, and of course the last one was gold, 2021. Both teams trying to get back on the podium, underway here in the third as Dvorsky was looking to cruise in. He was shut down by Dragicevic. Puck up the left side for Celebrini. He's checked by Sturback. Sent right back in. Dvorsky right back on the move. Canada trying to clear. Bouncing puck available right at the Team Canada line. Burns can't clear it and said so. Gave it away just out of the reach of Ritchie. And Ritchie on the move. Leading Team Canada in points in this tournament. And maybe interviews as Callum Ritchie does a pretty honest assessment of his team and what they have to do to shut things down here in this third period and come away with a massive win when it comes to group play. Riley Height tracking in. Height centering pass wanted Howe. That was a good stick by Pijoza. Broke that up in time in a dangerous spot. Colby Barlow. Bringing that physicality into the corner. Garson, he couldn't clear. And then taken down by Barlow. Shenko, a big hit on Howe. Things getting physical to open up things here in the third. Here's Howe, stretch pass. Poked away in time by Pekarsik. They've had a good little battle on this shift, those two players.
Caden Price is another defenseman here that's had a really good game. Taking his game and pushed it up another level. Been really strong for Canada.
Bertucci across, one-time drive, Gibson. And Furston might have got a touch of that. Pekarsik hit by Riley Height. Dej, he'll rumble in, picked up by Gibson. Gibson spins and reverses to Bertucci.
Nice calm play by Andrew Gibson below the goal line. And again, it's becoming more comfortable with the style of game your team wants to play and understanding the bigger rink, and you're seeing it throughout the defense group for Team Canada.
And just getting more comfortable with the larger ice, something that the coaching staff talked about as well. Game number three here for Team Canada. Kuchenberg brings it in, drops, it's our Richard score! They won't go away! What a shot by Cesar! Slovakia within one.
Yeah, real good pace. Baran starts us off. He beats the forecheck, and then through the middle of the ice comes Kuchenberg, but right behind him is Cesar. You know, you talk about being connected and, you know, being really organized with respect to your attack. That starts right with Baran all the way up the ice, but they're coming at you with speed, and you can see where Canada is just being pushed back. That's what happens when you build your speed and your pace, and an excellent shot at 2 minutes and 24 seconds into the third period. Canada's got a tiger by the tail, but Slovakia is competitive.
Peter Cesar with his first of the tournament massive goal, and a lot like that game versus Sweden, they are not going anywhere. Slovakia trying to tilt the ice here in Switzerland. Out comes Quinton Burns. He'll feed the left side for Haliburta. In comes Martone. Fran on the puck, round the boards. Martone, Haliburta. Up to Dragosivic. He's able to knock that down. Dragosivic works it in deep again for Team Canada. Fran couldn't get that centering pass in front. He'll try again. Kobizel lost it. Martone's got some space in. Shoots off the side of the net. Canada had a 3-0 lead in this game, and now two goals by Slovakia. They're within one. Martone across quickly. Allen shoots green in front. Wood jamming for it. Puck is still loose in front, and you saw Burston as he does, laying out in the crease. Another wrist shot, another stop, and this time he finds it with Matthew Wood, and Matthew Wood gets clobbered after the whistle, pushed down in front.
Referees are certainly allowing some more after the whistle physical play, especially in front of the net. You know, Wood's trying to get in there. Sturbrick says, get out of here. And I guess a little higher tolerance level of these referees for that. And certainly Furstin, it's a little bit of an acrobat. No, he's a lot of bit of an acrobat in there. They don't ask you how, sometimes they just tell you, just do it well.
Referees for the game are Jeffrey Barcello out of France, and out of Czechia is Ludvík Pilný. Faced off to the left of Lukas Furstin. Good physical battle in this game from both nations. And the head coach, Jeff Truitt, I mean, Craig, he knew it was coming. Hard forecheck, physical, never say die. All you got to do is pull the video from their first two games. That is Team Slovakia.
Yeah, you know, I was talking to Vaclav Nedoroš, who's the general manager of the Czechia team. He says, we can't lose to Slovakia. And I said, you know, okay, I know that there's a rivalry there, but that's a good Slovak team. Don't, you know, and he says, yeah, I know, but that's a competitor in me, and certainly... They serve notice versus Sweden. They serve notice to everybody that this is a team, Slovakia, that is going to play hard and play right to the end.
We saw USA-Norway last night for San Laura Dyken. She nailed that this is the group of death. It is a very tough group as Pioja starts the give and go. Jam play, Zedzo trying to get it in front. Rap try, Zedzo, it's loose, out of the net. Bjarnason looking for it, he found it, and just a mad scramble. It was sitting there covered up.
We were talking about some of the after whistle play, and we see another one here with Caden Price and Dalibor Dvorsky. Jeffrey Barcello, the referee from France, is calling a penalty here. Looks like Callum Ritchie is the one being targeted, along with the Slovak player Patrick Mesnicka. Well, there's two. While Caden Price and Dalibor Dvorsky certainly could be going off as well for some of the after whistle, but they're really after this puck. And Carson Bjarnason, right leg on that post, and really strong with his right arm, and making sure that that puck doesn't get any opportunity to get pushed past him. So we saw Dvorsky and Caden Price mixing it up well after the whistle. Ashnika, looked like Callum Ritchie was prepared to admit guilt and go right to the penalty box. Certainly the case.
So Sturback Barlow there waiting for an explanation. Two Slovak players in the box right now. One from Team Canada. And a great crowd here again, Craig. It's been a lot of fun. Good atmosphere.
It's awesome. I'm going to say it's got to be about 80% full on a Sunday afternoon here in Oshawa, Switzerland. And the intensity on the ice is sure heated up. There's some moments during the games here where it's been a little chilly in this arena, but that's not the case on the ice. It is heating up down there. I think it's fantastic, though. Slovakia, that was out of the top pool for a number of years, getting relegated, then the pandemic, and we saw what they did at the Olympics. We saw what they did at the World Junior, taking Canada right to overtime, and just couldn't overcome the spectacular playing of Connor Bedard, and coming here and doing the. And it's a good, promising group. Ivan Fenish, who's the head coach of the Slovak junior team, he's here evaluating some of these players. František Dež, Dalibor Dvorský, Maxim Štrbák, they were all on that World Junior team. And they're going to come back to the World Junior Tournament next year with a lot of good players. And, they're not happy to participate anymore. They want to win. They want to go in there with it. And they're going in with a greater expectation and of themselves that they can win.
So it looks like we got it sorted out, and it looks like Team Canada will be on the power play. The extra minor going to Slovakia. So good opportunity to have Canada try put the ice tilted back in their favor after two goals by Slovakia.
Now trying to get the net back into its proper place with the pegs.
And much like the tournament, Craig, and we chatted with the head coach before the game too, Jeff Truitt, saying, the power play against Sweden, it didn't look connected. It just wasn't together. But build. Tournament continues. Power play got better, and it looked better as it progressed versus Germany.
Well, and you've touched on this through the course of this game about Slovakia. You're going to be tested not just over the course of a tournament, but during the course of a game. And when you get a good competitor like Slovakia, a capable competitor, this is something that tests you. And, now an opportunity for Canada on the power play to try to restore a two-goal lead.
Height wins the draw, right back to Celebrini. He'll pop it across. Dragicevic keeps it moving. Height up top. Dragicevic, he'll walk the line. Riley Height works it down low. Height gets it back in the corner. A little pop pass. Back up to the point. Dragicevic. Height goes back to him. Dragicevic. Lukas Dragicevic waits. Riley Height. Down low, wanted that pass for Celebrini and broken up nicely by Slovakia. Celebrini able to just hold the line over to Height. Height works it down low. Matthew Wood. Wood at the goal line for Celebrini. Up top. One time drive tipped and Barlow was in front, just wide of the goalie. Colby Barlow back up top. Dragicevic assessing options. Back to Height. Dragicevic. Looking for that tip from Barlow, and he tips it out of play in Canada. A little frustrated right now.
Dave Reed talked about how Canada had to adjust their power play. How, if one thing's not working, try some different things. And they had that success versus Germany. But now Slovakia, who has been watching them, are saying, we're going to take some plays away from you. Time for another readjustment. You have your setup, but understand that how they're defending you, and then you try to work different plays. I'd like to see Dragicevic, when that play goes low, step in a little bit higher. They'll have a better shooting spot.
Good job by Kukenberg. He's in shorthanded to the puck first. Tries to flip it in front, picked up by Crystal. Andrew Crystal dumps it in. He saw Lardis coming in hot. He's there first. Lardis, the backhand into the corner. Crystal leaves for Catton. Up top for Allen. Allen thought about the shot. Works it over. Crystal back to Allen. Allen, wrist shot and through the screen. There's first in the glove save with 30 seconds left in the minor penalty.
Again,
that net presence. And there's some traffic in front of Burston, and but clearly sees the puck all the way through. You're near the net, but it's not what's going to get a goaltender distracted.
Port of Martel, here to take a critical draw for Canada. That's a good win back to Sturback. He's able to clear. Bukarsik coming in. And a good little poke by Bjarnason. Played it into the corner.
What I love about that play by Carson Bjarnason, you also have to know what your talents are. He didn't try to make a play. He just said, I'm putting it into the corner. I can see where my defenseman is. Don't make the play harder for yourself than it needs to be.
Shots 32-17 in favor of Canada. 3-2 advantage. Here's Allen as the power play comes to an end. That drive right on and handled again by Burston. Great job by Slovakia and a 2-on-1. Dvorsky withdrawn. Dvorsky, and it was tipped, and Bukarsik was looking for the pass. Drawn available and broken up by Canada. Bukarsik pinned by Catton. In comes Burns. Burns collects the puck. He'll chip it up the right wing for Crystal. Crystal works it across for Larnes. Wrist shot. That was high off the glass. He missed. Turnover. Crystal across again. That shot hit the mask. Larnes loading up. And that hit the mask. You can see it. Lucas Burston. And again, conversations after whistles. This thing, the temperature is escalating on this Sunday. It's the
most wonderful time. Non-drowsy Claritin provides 24-hour relief from symptoms caused by indoor and outdoor allergens. Feel the clarity and make today the most wonderful time of the year. Live Claritin Clear.
I can't believe this place is ours.
Should we go with Sunset Marigold or Bright Eyed Susan?
Oh, you are the pain specialist. I'm better at sorting out our mortgage, which was super easy with RBC.
Super easy.
They paired us with our own mortgage specialist to give us helpful advice and our best rate.
Another good idea.
Boom.
Does RBC need a pain specialist?
Maybe.
I can work with maybe.
Get up to $3,500 and 55,000 Avion points with an RBC mortgage. It's the
most wonderful time of the year. Non-drowsy Claritin provides 24-hour relief from symptoms caused by indoor and outdoor allergens. Feel the clarity and make today the most wonderful time of the year. Live Claritin Clear.
Welcome back to our coverage of the Under-18 World Hockey Championship. And here's a look at
This is how quickly things can happen. And, you know, at the end of a power play, you have some players that are tired. But there is a great play by Berkeley Catton coming back, never giving up on the play and poking it out of harm's way. But you had tired players at the end of the shift. So now you can't get invested in the board battle. And that's how Slovakia comes right up and gets that type of an opportunity. Got to be aware of your shift time. And, you know, when you're vulnerable like that, just get off a little bit sooner than staying on a little too long.
Burns up that left side. He'll dump it in. In comes Alex Fran. He'll chip into the corner. Dvorsky, who has a big goal in this hockey game, will lay it back. Up for Sedzo. He'll tip it in. Lukas Dragicevic. Find his own net. Up for Fran. Fran. Nice little chip. Try to get around Dej, but Bukarsik took it away. Bukarsik for Sedzo. Sedzo maneuvers back up top. And for Jesse, shoots. Wanted that deflection from Bukarsik in front. Dej in the corner. Lost it. Aliberta flips it up ahead for Fran. McDonnell was cruising in. Nice job, though, by Slovakia. Dump back down, and that'll be an icing charge against the Slovaks.
Such a good play by Ty Heilberger. Such a strong play. You don't have to try to make a play through the middle of the ice. He comes up the boards on the left-wing side of the defensive zone. I'm going to push the puck behind you, and we're going to make sure that we can get a line change. Turns into an icing. They're tired, Slovakia is, and now you get your top group out on the ice with a chance in the offensive zone.
Barlow, Richie, Martone, your goal scorers for Team Canada. Exciting finish to come. It's been a close game. It's been physical. A little bit of hatred in this one as well. Dej will bring it in. Dej, round the net. Can Slovakia do what they did versus Sweden and come all the way back and tie it up at 3 late? A lot of symmetry in both post games. Slovakia's got to try to do it one more time. There's the goal scorer as well. Cesar brings it into the corner. Him and Dvorsky have pulled the trigger successfully here for Slovakia. Up for Baran. Baran, high shot, missed glove side. Tanner Howe in his own corner. Howe, one on two, in comes Price to help. Chip to Allen, the captain. He'll move it up to the left side. Pass behind Height. He'll backhand it in. Gets spilled by Baran.
So many examples on that shift. Tanner Howe on the puck battle. Colby Barlow turning the right way. And then Riley Height at the neutral zone, not skating past the puck. And now you get a line change. All those little things add up to success.
Celebrini winding up the wheels with Richie. Trying to get it back to him. Celebrini in the corner. Good puck battle again as Canada tenacious in the offensive zone, trying to win that battle, but Slovakia away with the puck. Bobizel back to Baran. He'll sling a bouncer in, handled by Bjarnason. Bobizel coming in. Near miscue by Team Canada, but collected by Bertucci. Up for Wood. Wood drops it off. Celebrini cross ice, and the pass was behind Richie. Here's Burns. Look out. Bounced on him, and Pekarsik in. Pekarsik driving, round the net, tried the wrap job, comes up top, pass in front, Dvorsky just missing. Oh, what a chance that was for Slovakia. Pekarsik again. Pioja, they're working across. High wrister, Bjarnason, standing tall, made the stop, still bouncing behind the net. Under 10 minutes to go as Pioja slides it across. Pioja, high wrister, bodies in front, Bjarnason down, and the puck behind the net. Play still going. Puck not frozen. Burns. He takes contact in the corner. Slovakia starting to feel it. That shot blocked in front and finally out of play. And we got a hurt player in the corner, Quinton Burns. He is down on the ice here in Switzerland.
Spring into savings at the Spring into Action sale on now at Home Hardware.
Until Wednesday, save 15% on select ProMix lawn care and save 20% on Armstrong birdseed. Sale ends Wednesday at Home Hardware and Building Centers. Here's how.
Price alerts saved me an immense amount of time.
Time is money. You just sit back and wait for the app to tell you.
I can get notifications just to be able to know when that vehicle that I want is within my reach.
Hockey fans, get your Hockey Canada gear at shop.hockeycanada.ca. The official online store of Hockey Canada and the largest selection of Hockey Canada gear anywhere. Get jerseys, men's and women's tees, hoodies, headwear, and more. Don't miss out. Shop now and get today's special offer. Shop.hockeycanada.ca, a fanatics experience.
Well, Quinton Burns being helped off the ice, and it was heavy contact, both racing for a puck, and Dalibor Dvorsky gets right in on his hip. You're going to see right here, and just squishes him up against the boards and kicks the puck back. Quinton Burns is in all kinds of trouble, and here's the play that starts off. Pekarsik, he loses the puck, but he stays right on it, comes around and right up to the point, and then Dvorsky has a great chance to redirect it and heals it. But certainly right now you're looking at Slovakia really pushing the tempo, pushing the pace.
And they win the draw. The captain on the puck, stir back space, wrist shot, glove stop, rebound available, cleared by Canada. As Slovakia is finding another gear here in this third period. Here's Dvorsky. He'll walk it in again. Drops it off. Big hit there as Andrew Gibson applying the body.
Well, we talk about the defenseman becoming more comfortable. So Andrew Gibson reads that play and he's not backing off on his heels. He moves right into the path and takes him right off the puck. That's a great example of the defenders becoming more comfortable with their spacing.
Clean win back to Brand. Brand, good stick as that was picked off. Martone with Mac Donnell. Mac Donnell cutting in, screen available, puck still loose for Haliburda. Bartow, second try, and it's jammed into the corner. Again, that was Mac Donnell creating opportunity for Canada. He's had a strong game again. Dej brings it in, he'll chip and uses big frame, chasing after the puck. Oh, and that's a tough hit on Andrew Gibson. And that should be a boarding call. We'll see what the call is, but Gibson's now down.
That was a penalty. The referee has his hands up. I'm going to think that they might review this. They are going to review it. There's no question about it. In the first game against Sweden, Andrew Gibson got hit in a similar spot. And right there on the back, you know what? You know, Dej, who's a big body, Gibson's trying to turn away from it, turn inside of it, and I didn't see Dej really moving up his feet or trying to drive through him. He leans into him. You know, they're calling a 5-minute and the review. This is what you have to do. It merits a penalty. I think it's of the 2-minute nature. That would be my positioning on it, but I don't have any say, Brian.
Well, you mentioned his big frame. He is. He's 6'4", 202 pounds.
But so what I'm looking
customer.
What I'm looking for there is, he driving through the player? Does he get into a spot? See, he tries to turn and he leans down. It's boarding. There's no question it's boarding, but for me, that doesn't merit. It's a play where he's not trying to go through the player on the backside, and Gibson turning back into it, which he's totally allowed to do. It doesn't give you the right to take a liberty with a player, but the referees are giving it a good look.
And Gibson, he looks fine. I'm just checking him out. He's on the bench, talking to his teammates. Looks to be okay. And
yeah,
still waiting to see if it's two or the five. And remember, already down a defenseman, Quinton Burns, so it's good to see that Gibson appears to be all right.
Well, talking to Jeff Truitt before the game, and one of the things coaches always have to be aware of, they establish their top four defensemen, and then what they have to do is understand, okay, if one of our top four defensemen gets hurt, who's the next guy that's going to go on and take those minutes? And, you know, one of the things, watching the group of players, you know, really kind of move forward. And you know, that's Bertucci, that's Yakimchuk, and Gibson. Somebody, if Burns is out, is one of those three are going to have to move into a top 4 minutes role. So, but they've shown that they've really become more comfortable with the ice, with the space, more decisive in their play. They are. They're like, take as much time as you need, not an inordinate amount of time, but as much time as you need to feel confident about what to call. Because this is a big call.
Well, critical. You're right. Critical time in the game. And it looks like we now have a decision. So just the 2 minutes. Power play opportunity for Canada. 2-minute minor for boarding. Regardless, great opportunity for Jeff Truitt and Team Canada to try to get a little insurance here in the third period with a team that we know all too well will not go away, will not quit battling.
Opportunity here for Team Canada to really push Slovakia to the edge.
Height, another good face-off win for Canada. Dragasevic. Riley Height, Celebrini, pop pass, one-time drive into the glove by Lucas Ferson. Good shot from Dragasevic.
No net presence, though. You gotta, maybe, goaltenders are too good, and when they see the puck clearly, that's like picking out, playing catch in your backyard.
Good clear by Slovakia off the draw. Dragasevic back. Slovakia full change. Four fresh penalty killers. Minute 40 power play time. Dragosivic through center ice. Cutting in. Dragosivic, we saw him pull off some magic versus Germany on the power play with a highlight reel goal. Dragosivic, he'll drop it off. Height bobbled it, and an easy clear there for Kuchenberg in Slovakia.
Dave Reed was such a superb penalty killer in the National Hockey League for his career, successful career. But, you know, one of the things that Dave talks about is the adjustments you have to make and on a power play. What's the opponent doing to you, and how can you take advantage?
Barlow for Dragosivic. Colby Barlow. Down low height. Woods parked in front. Celebrini. Wood trying to get that pass. Comes to Barlow. Up for Dragosivic. Barlow. Down low. Wood. Good stick as Nika took that away. Canada though holds the line in the zone. Up for Dragosivic. Dragosivic. Canada keeps it moving. 30 seconds left. Height. That shot again blocked. Never got through. Barlow. Dragosivic. Thought about the shot. Height in front. Wood the tip. That was wide. Celebrini goes to work. Gets it to Dragosivic. Dragosivic. Wood. Celebrini. Tucks it in. Up top. Score. What a goal. No space. No problem. And Celebrini. Power play goal. And Canada leads by two.
He retrieves the puck in the corner. He's on it. Gets it back up to the point. And again, take the puck to the net. And as Fürsten shows him that short side up over the left shoulder, Celebrini's hands are magic, and he's not going to make any mistake about it. Just a little step in. Just beautiful. You give it to the good players. The good players are going to bury you every time. And back when Celebrini buries it, what a play. And certainly with 6:55 left here in the third period, that goal is really significant. A little bank shot. You know, if first it just stands there, there's no problem. Just stand there. Don't go down. Don't go down on one knee. Just stand there. The good players are going to take full advantage of that, and that's exactly what Macklin Celebrini did. I was just going to finish my thought on Dave Reed Panikin. Good penalty killers and smart penalty killers that are looking for certain things. And if you keep doing those things and doing what the penalty killers are expecting, you're going to have a hard time having success on the power play. And that's why Dave was talking about mixing it up, trying to change some of your strategies and the options that you have to throw off the penalty killers.
Brand looking for more. Spins around, throws it up top. 4-2, Canada leads. Esperiesi, the turnover. Kuchenberg, some space. Kuchenberg, backhand try. Off the side of the net. Macklin Celebrini with the celebration. And why not? What a beauty for his first of the tournament.
Yeah, Matthew Wood lays it there. And then Celebrini's coming right. But watch where his stick position. It's outside the goal line or above the goal line. And then as Fürsten goes down, there it is, right off the back of the helmet, side of the mask, and 4-2.
Jenko on the puck in the corner for Slovakia. Cameron Allen up top, but not out. Jam back in for Jenko. Jenko below the goal line. Hit by Price. In comes Pioza. Dej. Tried to center that puck. Shift down the ice by Team Canada. Halliburton's got a little bit of runway. Halliburton shoots, and enough by Fürsten. Kept it out. Pioza. Through center ice, he'll dish to Dej. Knocked off his stick. Tanner Howe in transition. He's got Crystal. Crystal, bobbling puck. Trying to get there first to jam it in. Crystal, and he was out of real estate. He tried to throw it in front, and Gron the other way. Gron, and Yakimchuk got back in time. Didn't give him a clean shot. Tanner Howe drops it off. Crystal. Crystal in the corner. Back to the line. Bertucci, wrist shot. And it was behind the net as Fürsten didn't see it. Bertucci missed the mark. Another turnover. And again, it's Crystal. That's one guy that would love to get one here in Switzerland, Andrew Kristall, just to get that weight off his shoulders. And then sneak a shot off a stick and out of play. Massive goal by Macklin Celebrini, who's celebrating in Switzerland.
RS is more than a style. It's a mindset where bold choices are the norm and style matters. It's a reminder, whatever you do, keep it RS. Introducing the 2023 Chevrolet Equinox RS and Blazer RS. Discover yours and keep it RS. Find new style, find new roads.
Welcome back to our coverage, Under 18 World Hockey Championship in Ashwa. Local time, nearly 3:30 p.m. And Team Canada trying to wrap up a massive victory over Slovakia in group play. Lovely goal from Macklin Celebrini. Just when you think there's not enough space, well, you better think again. The star players always find a way, and they do. Give them an inch, and they'll bury one, and he did just that. Under 5 minutes to go here in this third period. And that'll be icing versus Canada. The only blemish to this game is Quinton Burns, that injury, and we just hope it's not very serious for Team Canada.
Yeah, that's what you hope for. But back to Macklin Celebrini again on that little play. It ends up being an icing, but it's coming off of a TV timeout, so nobody's tired. But not trying to mess around with the puck, trying to make a play. I'm trying to make a flip play to get it down the ice. Smart situational hockey.
He might put Callum Ritchie's slogan in the dressing room. No toe dragging around the blue line. That could be one of the calling cards for this team going forward. Wood in pursuit of the puck. Played to center ice. Dragosevic. He'll get it back. Lost the puck though, turnover, Zhenko, Celebrini there, back defensively in a good play. Chips it down the ice, right to Eppergesi, right back to Dragosevic.
So you can see what decision the coaching staff has made. With Andrew Gibson now playing with Lucas Dragosevic. So they've made the decision that he is going to be the player that's going to move up and take those top 4 minutes. And, you know, not easy for Andrew Gibson either. He's the right shot. He's going to play on the left side. But we've seen that in some of their configurations on the blue line and their pairings where he's had to play on that side. So through your play, through your understanding of what it takes to play on that side of the ice, you see Bruce Richardson now talking to him. That's how you build confidence, not just in your game, but in the coach's confidence in you being able to get in there and carry those minutes.
Caden Price up the left wing, shoots it in. Fran on the move in the corner, hits Kuchenberg. Haliburta couldn't hold the zone. It's bouncing all the way to Bjarnason. He takes a look, and he's going to hold for a faceoff. 3 minutes, 33 seconds here in this third period.
And that fourth goal seems to have taken some zip out of Slovakia. You know, when they made it 3-2, they had some jump and some giddy up in their step, and they were really pushing and in that penalty that, you know, and it came off of a good rush, the penalty, because Dvorsky just missed at the edge side of the net, and then Dej took that boarding penalty, and Canada takes advantage on the power play, but not the same zip. That happened with just over 8 minutes left in the third period. So it's about a 5 minute stretch here where Slovakia has had some of the air taken out of their balloon.
Slovakia will wrap up group play versus Germany. Canada will wrap up group play versus Czechia, which will also be a tough test. Czechia, another one of those teams, much like Slovakia, has some star power. Led by Edward Schala, plays super hard. Nothing is given to you in this tournament. Ty Halaberta through center right, watched by Cesar. He'll backhand it in. And time now, the enemy of Slovakia as well in this contest. Just over three to go. Sturback at the line. Braun in his skates, trying to get a shot away. He'll take it into the corner. In by Dragicevic. Cesar digs the puck loose up for Baran. Baran works it across Sturback. Long wrist shot. That was blocked. That stung Andrew Gibson. Here's some space for Height. In comes Height. Delay shoots and a good stop. Burston. Keeping Slovakia's hopes alive in the game. Height delivers a saucer pass across. Gibson shoots. And that's up high and deflects out of play.
Riley Height, who played on the Hlinka-Gretzky gold medal winning team in the summer for Team Canada, obviously, you know, becomes available because his Prince George Cougars are knocked out of the playoffs. But you think about ending a playoff series, finding a way to get on a plane and flying all the way across overnight, getting some sleep, and getting a skate in on Saturday and coming out here today. I talked about it, about the options that he gives the coach. They're high-end options, and Riley Height has been terrific in this game for Team Canada.
72 assists, 97 points in the Western League. He brings out offense here to Team Canada. Pekarsik at center ice. Works at Dvorsky. Tried to drop it back. Gibson took that away and sends that up the left side.
Just the space, right? Comfortable with the space. I'm going to get up in that spot on the ice. I'm comfortable. Deny it and then make the play. Very nicely done by Andrew Gibson.
Pioja for Mancica. Mancica. Said so. Down on the pass. And Richie picks it up for Team Canada. Richie tried to put it to space. Net empty. So Burston out of the net. Extra attacker up for Slovakia. All systems go as they're down by two. Played cross ice. Picked up by Sedzo. And he literally waltz in. Sedzo tried to center pass. Look out. The net is empty. That would have been a heartbreaker as Mesnika's back.
How about Callum Ritchie coming out of the defensive zone? There was no toe drag at the blue line.
Draw pass to Halaberta was nearly all over it. Minute 20 to go in the game. Slovakia down by two. In comes Sturback. He'll shoot it in. Mazníka there with Kuchenberg. Sedzo sends it into the corner. Price takes a look, wraps it along the wall, and it pops to center ice. Sturback collects. Sedzo. Slovakia comes in again. Dvorsky takes the puck. Under a minute to go in the hockey game. Dalibor Dvorsky up for Sturback. Sturback, wrist shot, deflected, score! Deflection in front, and Pekarsik again. They're not going anywhere. Slovakia down by one.
50.4 left in the game, and Pekarsik, who's had some really good chances. Again, Dvorsky making the play on it, and a real nice play back to Sturback. And Sturback just gets it to the net, and the redirect by Pekarsik. Again, making sure that you get the puck through, number one, and then Pekarsik with the little tip deflection. And timeout coming here for... Here's the play again, and the puck just skips the other way on Bjarnason. But Dvorsky got them started on the scoreboard. Makes a play here, and then now here's Pekarsik, just with the little redirect, just a little push back the other way, and there's no way that Bjarnason can get to that one. Now Bruce Richardson making sure that everybody has their direction clear.
Remember back on Friday, Craig, we've talked about it. It was a big push back late as Mancica cut in. And then Kuchenberg tied it up at three. So, never sleep on Slovakia. This is a team with bite, with battle. They didn't just show up, Hero. We're back in a big tournament for the first time since 2019. No chance. They're here to compete and try to get to that podium. And Canada now up by one, 50.4 seconds remaining. So Lucas Fersten's back in his net. Five on five, but you know he'll make his way as soon as he can.
We're going to put some time back up on the clock. It was 50.4 and it ran down to 49.5. So we'll get that readjusted. But you just watch his face-off. Watch how the players are on the face-off. It's intense. And that's been created because of the competitiveness of these two teams.
Riley Height chips it in for Canada. Is there one more Slovakia miracle on the ice here in Switzerland? Pekarsik. What a story he's been in the tournament. He'll drop it back. And again, first it to the bench. Extra attacker out. Ezika jumps on the ice. 25 seconds remaining in the game. Sturback, wrist shot. Big traffic in front, never got through. Sturback, one more time. Goes down low. Kuchenberg, centering pass, loose in front. Bodies everywhere in front. And Sturback again. Big block height. As the puck was inside of him, and Barlow found it, able to knock it out. He doesn't have a stick. Time winding down as the puck into the corner. Dragosevic, one last touch, and wow. Team Canada literally hanging on, but they pick up a massive win over Slovakia.
The entire team, I should say the entire team, but they know the importance of what Riley Height just did. They come off the bench, and they go right over to Riley.